Hello and welcome back. Today, we have the Valorant Grand Finals starring our very own UMW Eagles versus the Brooklyn College Bulldogs. I'm one of your two hosts, Connor, accompanied by my wonderful co-host, Jack. Say hello, Jack.
Hello, everybody. How are we doing tonight? Thank you so much for joining us and supporting your fellow Eagles on the stream tonight. We're going to have a wonderful set for you guys, like Connor said, against Brooklyn College. very exciting stuff. I am super ecstatic going into this. What do you think we're going to see coming into this?
I think we're going to see some great Valorant, some wonderful plays, hopefully from both sides, but I know we're going to get it from our UMW boys.
That is very true. I mean, if you guys remember the stream on Friday, we did see a bit kind of different comp being played, especially with Mason on those duelists and just like, you know, with Xander holding it down on the chamber and Jax switching over to the KO, I think has been working really well for this team. However, grand finals, got to start thinking of like, what new strategies can we bring to the table? What differences can we make in our gameplay to really throw these guys off, like off their own game?
Indeed. But I know they got it. What maps are we going to be talking about
tonight? So, getting into the map pool, we're going to be starting off with Attack on Bind, then moving into Attack on Ascent, followed by Attack on Icebox, and then switching positions indefinitely to starting with Haven on defense, same thing with Fracture starting on the defense. What do you think about that map pool?
I think, I'm a little sad about Bind, but I know play good on our Ascent game is crazy. And I know our boys can play pretty well on Icebox. So I'm not too scared.
I do agree. The boys do have a bit of a little shaky history with Bind. However, they are always able to keep their mindset together, keep those rounds rolling in and still bringing the map to the end. And like you said, Ascent and even Icebox, some of our best maps just roll, like doing phenomenally with that right there.
Well, last time I talked about it. So, do you want to get into the merch?
Oh boy, would I. You know, we've been waiting all semester for this, and it's finally happened. We have our own UMW Esports merch. However, this is very important. Tomorrow is the last day you are able to order merch. You've had an entire week, so if you've been missing out on that just then, why don't you head over to the link and pick yourself up some merch. I know myself, I have bought a long sleeve shirt, short sleeve shirt, and sweatpants, and I've known people who bought a lot more than that. So, you know, why don't you just head over to the store? How about you? What have you gotten so far?
I've gotten the hoodie, the Nike hoodie, and I got a pair of sweatpants.
The hoodie looked nice. And hey, you know, obviously, if it's a little out of your price range, Christmas is coming.
It'll
be here by then, and even then, a little belated Christmas gift's always nice. But, yeah, why don't you bring it back home for us?
All right. So, again, we're going to be going into this next match somewhat shortly. And, yeah, I'm excited to see the Bind gameplay.
I'm very excited to see starting off on Bind. However, we will get back to you guys in just a few minutes. Don't go anywhere when we get into game one.
Or do, your loss. Welcome back, everyone. we're about to start here. You're the analyst here, Jack. Why don't you tell us something about these team comps?
So we're seeing something very interesting on the side of UMW. We're seeing Mason not on a duelist that he's been playing recently. We see Mason on the Sky. We see Jack on the Viper. He's been putting the work in, especially with the start of the season. Mm-hmm. He's had that chamber, but obviously Xander's kind of picked that up, roll up for him, and he's been really performing on that character, especially after the nerfs. On Friday, he was really showing that it doesn't matter. He could still pop off. He could still frag with chamber. But Jack really kind of sitting in a little with the KO, but it looks like the Viper kind of a mix-up. I mean, they immediately picked this comp. They knew exactly what they were going for in. And again, I mean, Brandon with the tried and true fade. And Colby, again, we've seen what Colby's able to do with this Brimstone here. The Colby clutch
Select
factor. Such a strong tool UMW has in their kit. But I'm very interested to see how is Jack going to perform on the Viper and how Mason is going to perform on the Sky.
Speaking of that Colby clutch factor, we actually have a poll for you all. Do y'all think that the Colby clutch factor will come into play in today's match? Feel free to answer. This is definitely not biased. This is completely unrigged. This is the fairest election known to mankind.
But it looks like on the side of Brooklyn, we are going to see a duelist in the form of Raze and a bit more intel with Sova instead of a fade. So it's going to be really interesting to see how, especially starting off on defense, not very defense-oriented characters going immediately. And you already hear that Viper wall coming down, maybe giving a little intel, but we'll end up having to see right there. I mean, Mason's just looking up in the sky. He knows. He knows what's up. If you catch my drift right there. But
nice one.
Thank you. it's gonna be really interesting to see how this team kind of works with this different comp. And I mean, Colby with the frenzy right there. So obviously, even with the changes, these guys still have a bit of their comfort picks rolling in. Looks like we're going to see Jack immediately with the lineup right there. Ooh. Following that smoke, it's going to be dropped in right there. Beautiful. And already Mason getting a pick. We're not even done talking about startup, and he's already catching in a limb.
It sounds like Mason. It sounds like Mason.
Very true.
All right, he's going to collect that orb there, and he's going to slowly start pushing on the site. Playing this very carefully.
That Sky Flash gave away opposing Sky's position. Now he knows Sky is somewhere on site, but Jack gonna make an aggressive push into Hookah, catching Chamber, and winning the duel. But sadly, Xander is gonna fall, and so is Brandon to Kira.
Colby planting Spike.
The Molly coming out.
Ooh.
Colby picking up one onto the Raze, and the Flash coming out. Flashes for both teams coming out. It's hard holding this angle right there. And Jack
getting that final pick, really securing that round.
Beautiful. I mean, already we're in round one, and Jack looks very comfortable on this Viper pick immediately, using that wall to his advantage, using those lineups to give himself and his team that position to be able to take sight, especially with Mason going for a little bit of a B push. You know, he found one off of it, and that really swung that round into UMW's favor.
Yeah, that was a really quick elim. I as you said in the moment, we didn't even get to finish talking about the lineup.
So we're going to see what kind of interesting stuff. It looks like a three-man Sovadar right there, but Xander already finds one. Basically going for a hard pick. Oh,
Brandon finds two,
but falls to Chamber as he TPs out of there. But that's huge. That gives so much control.
Ooh, Mason pushing with the dog. Looking for anyone.
But not finding anyone, but he has an idea. He knows Chamber is still there.
Ooh, sprang through the free fire.
Sprang through the smoke. But now
Jack
they know.
Planting spike.
Setting up. Now this is where this team is really going to shine. With that Brimstone, with that Chamber, with that Viper. Post plant. How is this team going to be able to play it right here?
Colby holding that angle. Will he push?
Mason's held so carefully. They now know where Chamber is. Chamber going to find one on the Xander right there. Making the push forward.
Ooh,
and Mason
getting that pick. Colby watching. Playing it safe. And able to get that Elim.
Oh my gosh.
He was scared.
Such an aggressive push through the smoke by that enemy Brimstone. He really tried to catch Colby off guard right there, but Colby said, "You hold up. Wait a minute. I'm ready for you."
If it was me in that situation, I'd be wondering why I'm playing a horror game.
That's very true. Those jump scares left and right. But it looks like the boys are a bit unfazed by that. But I mean, looking at this buy right here, you know, Xander probably going to save a bit more. Xander going to probably save a bit more, try to get an elimination with that Chamber Deagle. All
right, it seems like they're pushing. Jack looking for a lineup.
He's looking for this another lineup. This is the lineup we saw in round one. Mason going for a bit of a jump peek, seeing if he can catch someone off guard, but not finding anyone.
Gonna flash out,
but not finding
really pushing
anyone.
Up. Very aggressive push here from these three. Toxin screen down. Jack watching showers. Oh, able to get a pick.
Great.
Already putting this into a 5v4 situation.
And here comes Mason with the heals. But that's such an important important character for Brooklyn right there. They lose that smoke. They lose that Molly. They lose so much. But now Jack, he gains a Vandal. This is huge for the side of UMW right now.
Xander over watching B. Using that Chamber Deagle, he's pushing slowly.
Not finding anyone just yet. Oh, it looks
Jack getting picked off by the enemy.
30 seconds left.
Nothing happening just yet. He's here, some footsteps behind him.
UMW as they push on the site.
Looks like they're making a B push, but Chamber gonna find Colby. Oh. Chamber gonna find Xander. But Mason finding. Now it is a 2v3. Bomb going down. They know where they are though.
Brendan plants spike.
Brendan
starts to rotate.
Mason finding one. Now it's a 2v2 again. How is Brandon going to be able to help us out right here? The pop defuse coming out. Brandon finds one. And Mason goes down. Getting pulled in right there.
Oh, unable to get that Elim.
Very unfortunate right there, but very well played. That was... You know, they got as many as they could going down from that two, that really big 4v2 to a 1v1 at the end. You know, that might not be great in terms of rounds, but that's great in terms of economy. Yeah. They lost a lot of weapons right there. And it looks like it's going to be a full buy on the side of both teams, possibly.
Ooh. It looks like it is.
Yep. Now we're getting into the meat of the match right here, round four. This is where the economy and the ults really start to take effect. Jack, so close to Viper Pit right now. Oh, Jack, here comes the Chamber ult. Flash coming out from Sky. Dog coming out from Mason.
Colby watching showers. Need to get a pick.
Not finding anyone right now. Colby stuck. Colby finding one.
Unable to find the second.
Now it is a 3v3.
Ooh, will Mason be able
to Raze ult coming out. Yep.
Oh, unfortunately, Mason going down to the Raze ult.
Picking off that corner right there.
Jack popping that Viper wall. An intel.
Making an aggressive push with the drone right there. Not spotting anyone. Xander played really well around that drone, not to get spotted too early. But now the wall's down. Now the boys have to play. Very careful, that Chamber ult narrowly missing Jack. Now Xander's in a bit of a 2v1 struggle for himself.
Now it's a 3v1.
Now it's a 3v1 without bomb. This is very big. He got sent to the other site by that Chamber ult.
They sent him to the Shadow Realm.
Brooklyn College tying it up 2-2 right there going into that bye round. Now UMW's kind of got to bring the tempo back in their favor. Chamber, he's got the op. He saved enough. Mm-hmm. He's got the op, but it looks like UMW's going to go for almost a full save right now. Keeping with the pistols, you got two sheriffs, you got the two frenzies. Very interesting to see, you know, what's going to happen.
Indeed.
Every elimination, especially with this round, counts. And if they're able to get that operator, that's going to be huge. being found out. Found out, but not spotting Sova. Aw.
They're unfortunately getting picked off by the enemy chamber. Mason continuing to fire the smoke.
Brandon, what are you trying to do, my guy? What kind of crazy shenanigans are you trying to go for right now? They still have a minute to play with. The Sova Dart coming out, but not getting a scan off, but they still know they're in there. Flash coming out, not finding anyone. Jack just trying to play around his wall right now. We have two completely different interactions going on two completely different sites. The smokes are down. The smokes are back. Another.
30 seconds left.
I mean, now you got to start grouping up. This is really important right now, playing with the members you have. Jack making an aggressive push, but not finding anything. But are they going to be able to get the one onto Raze? It looks like not.
Ooh, Brandon finding one.
And now he has the judge. Is he able to pull that out in time? Oh, yes, he is!
Judge Brandon!
Brandon finding two.
Seek them out.
Nope. Oh, unfortunately going down. 1v3 scenario for Mason, and Mason just cannot pull it off.
No. That's very difficult, but, you know.
It's a really sticky situation.
It really is, but Brandon making the most out of it, getting two eliminations from Lanterns right there. That was really important for him and UMW's economy. But Raze dropped the Vandal. You gotta think now, maybe if he picked up that Vandal, would it have been different? But it looks like a full buy is coming out. Chamber, this is really bad. Keeping that up.
That chamber is a menace.
That is very true. But UMW does have the ults on their side. They have that Brim ult. They have Brim ult. They have Viper ult. They have Fade ult.
They have Nightmare.
Really big for them.
Mason.
Chamber trip Mason's going down.
Brandon pushing pretty long here.
Dog coming out inside of the Mason. Not finding anyone just yet, but it looks like we still have. Who is that? Jack?
Yep.
On A.
Yeah, that's.
Well, they know where they are. They know those weird angles right now.
Is that Jack and Colby?
Yep.
Ooh,
they know exactly where he is. And Sova's gonna go down for it.
Ooh, oh. Mason attempting to push Hookah, going down.
But Xander covers his back right there. Now we have a 3v3. And Bomb is going down as well.
Welcome to my world.
Ooh. Oh, and Xander finding it onto Sky. There go the heals. That could be really important. And now the Viper ult coming out.
There.
Oh.
Finding the one onto Raze. And now it's just Chamber. Now it's just Chamber, but they hear him running away. Jack, gonna get a little aggressive here.
Ooh.
Ooh, what a molly. That was huge. Going for maybe the double peek, but getting the collateral.
Not worth it. Chamber still has that op, though.
That's very unfortunate. The boys trying to take Chamber down before the bomb goes. However, getting traded 2-4-1 in that situation. But they did get the round.
They did get the round.
They did get
and
the round.
Colby also saved. He was able
Colby
to keep his Phantom.
That is very true. That could be good for UMW's economy, but it looks like the buying is going to be a little bit on the scarce side right now.
Indeed. They just need to take out that Chamber.
That is very true. The Chamber and the Raze have been such important threats
to
UMW's comp right now. But it looks like we're going to start playing.
Brandon pushing shit.
Not finding anyone just yet.
Picking up that orb.
Shots are being fired, but no eliminations are being found.
Jack is holding that angle.
Bring them down.
Xander has pulled out.
Xander finds one! And Colby finds one!
Already a 4v3.
Little bit
situation.
Of Z-Boy gaming.
Oh.
But Colby is going to fall to the opposing Brim ult. Oh. He knows. Ooh. Oh, Xander finding another one and Jack finding Sova.
4v1 situation.
Teleport's ready.
Now it's just Brimstone. Oh, but look on the map right there. Boys are holding every single angle right now.
Poison's off.
They know where Brimstone is. This could be really big for his push, but it looks like he's gonna detour around a little bit. Maybe head towards showers. Get a push through there. We'll just have to see. But he doesn't have time anymore.
He doesn't.
Doesn't have time. Is he gonna be taken out by the bomb? No, it looks like he's gonna be safe. That is big for UMW. That's two rounds in a row that they're unable to defuse.
That's wonderful momentum, and they were able to get rid of that op.
That is very true, but...
I mean, Chamber's kind of struggling now.
Yeah. That's good, because now the opposite chamber, our chamber,
yeah,
has that op in his possession. So this could be really good for the tempo of UMW right now, seeing how these players now play with kind of what they got going for him. But it looks like already Jack, just this setup is working so well for him.
Ooh. I'm excited to see what Xander can line up.
Oh.
Xander already getting a elim with that op.
Oh, and Colby saw Brimstone, but just wasn't able to react fast enough for him.
That's okay. He's alive.
Got the idea of where he is.
Jack
hard pushing through that smoke right now, but not finding anyone. Ooh. And he finds Brimstone!
Rushing through. Still checking all those corners. He's aggressive, but he's methodical.
Oh, look at Colby right now. Oh, no.
Got the spike.
Chose his mind, picked up spike, and now here they go on a push to B. Looks like Jack's still going to stick on A. Playing a little bit more of a lurker role right now with the...
Ooh, that's so without failing to pick up Mason.
Nope.
That's
coming Jack's out.
Still over there.
But he heard the footsteps.
So he knows to rotate.
And he's gonna flank right behind him, but unknowing to them, this could be huge.
Mason up top,
Mason
finding
one. And Jack
finding the raise.
Oh my
god, further.
Jack. What are you doing?
Pinching
Where
that
does
Sova,
he go?
And Jack finds that Sova. A wonderful end to a flawless round.
Jack with three, fantastic flank from behind. Just they, you know, Viper, sometimes. Character lets you play like a rat, and right there gave Jack,
don't call Jack a rat.
All the tools to be able to play just how he wanted.
That was a beautiful round.
Here,
I'll spare y'all from the cringy
here.
eagle
pods. Boom, one goes down, and then the second right there making out a 3k for Jack, and now the round's already going in.
Oh,
aggressive push on the Jack. They just know he's going to be there every time now, so they just taking it. But Colby, finding two.
Almost finding the third. Unfortunately, had Molly out. But
now
it's still a 3v3 situation.
Now we're at a 3v3 still. Mason, not going to find anyone just yet.
Enemy chamber, unfortunately, taking out Xander, meaning they lose that op.
But Brandon gonna find Sova.
Mason watching angle.
As Brandon goes for the plant, chamber just sitting right there. He's got the exact idea. And now he knows where chamber is. That is insane intel for UMW. Now they're just holding these angles, making sure no one just peeked. Mason finding one onto Brimstone.
Can Brandon find Chamber? Can Mason find Chamber?
Mason. Topping his teammate off, making sure he has all the health he needs for the next battle. Kind of we're going to see. Not finding anyone.
Ooh.
Oh!
And Mason finds that Chamber and picks up the op.
Yep, that's huge for the eco. So, what are your thoughts going into what will be round 10 right now? What are you thinking? How do you think UMW's, like, comp is just working
I think it's working really well for them. I personally have never seen Jack Clay Viper.
Nope.
But he's doing an excellent job. He's extremely comfortable. Jack is typically an aggressive player, but he's methodical about it. He checks all his corners. He pushes efficiently and only moves as fast as he can.
That's very true. And he's playing so patient and just using these lineups and just being able to support his team in a way that we have not been, like, we haven't seen during their playoffs, and especially earlier in the the final stages. So it's really nice. It's enjoyable.
Indeed. And to just finish up my discussion and analysis, I need Xander to teach me how to use the op. Ooh, is Jack gonna push that?
But he's not gonna find anything.
Oh, unfortunate. Mason holding that lineup. Mason pushing into the smoke.
Not finding anyone. Finding two.
Can he find a third?
Oh my god.
Maybe a fourth. Sending that Hawk out.
Mason's in a tough position right now.
Unfortunately, unable to find that third. Olby sending out that ult.
Not finding anyone.
But keeping them off. Arguably more important. Finding that one guy.
Finding two, finding three! The Colby clutch factor!
Hey, we said it would happen.
And it happened. Oh my gosh, this Brimstone easily becoming his best character right now. Let's see the replay. Obviously, too beautiful. Let's give Mason credit as well. Two beautiful one taps.
Indeed.
But right there.
Colby sends out that ult. He's patient. Now we can see the raise coming.
Mm-hmm.
So I was starting to panic a little bit, but he acts just in time, takes both of them out. Ollie gets
beautiful stuff coming out from Colby. I mean, oh, and beautiful coming out from Xander, finding it onto raise.
Ooh, I didn't even notice that.
Crazy momentum. We're not even done talking about the Colby clutch, and we already have the Xander entry frag.
Ooh, boys are playing real aggressive. Again, as I keep saying, methodical though.
But now you can see right there, Jack has that Viper ult. Here comes out the dog. There's the Sova, and Xander finds the Sova as he was going to take down the dog. That's so big.
Jack was waiting for that wall and that orb. He's gonna push through the wall.
Not finding anyone.
Oh, ooh, finding Brim.
But not finding anyone else out of it.
I've been smoked off.
Not finding Jack gonna find
another one?
No, getting.
Oh, unfortunately, Jack goes down.
Falling the sky.
Real aggressive, finding one.
Oh!
And Xander taking out the last one in heaven. Ooh.
This is madness.
This is glorious. What you're calling madness, I'm calling a good game.
This is a good game.
Now, this is last round before the swap, if you want to.
I mean, it really is just like, you know, spend all, as you can see, with the BC Brim right now. Completely maxed out, credit out. However, Jack still has that Viper ult. That could be really big to keep holding sight right now, but we're going to be able to see as a three-man aggressive push coming out from BC. Not finding anyone just yet. Chamber TPing out of there. Now it's two, but Xander finding one.
Oh.
Spike down, B.
Oh, Colby unfortunately going down. Xander watching D long.
Not finding anyone, but Xander is getting healed up. That's really important, but he has no shield. Jack doing a couple tricks right there as he pushes onto site, but does he know? Oh, he saw!
Jack has had a set path this entire game. You notice that?
That is very true. He has a full streamlined game plan.
Oh!
Interesting stuff.
Popping his ult.
Ooh!
Xander finding one, but Jack and Brandon unfortunately going down. It's just Mason.
That's very true.
Oh, it's just Xander.
It's just Xander in a 1v3.
Oh, and Xander unfortunately goes down. But let's remember, Bind, incredibly defensive.
That is very true. And if there's one thing that this team comp has, it's defensive capability. You got two smokes. You got the blind. You got, like, the flashes. You have everything you need right now to make sure you hold sight down from the enemies.
What are they doing?
What is happening?
Get your head in the game, boys. It's grand finals.
Well, well, you know, we saw Jack on attack. Now we're seeing Jack. Now we're seeing the Viper on defense. Maybe needs a little more work with that. There goes the dog.
That's hard to hit.
That is actually a very hard one way to hit. However, if he stood back a little bit more, he would have got it. As a Viper player myself, it took me way too long to be able to do that properly.
Lineups are difficult.
Lineups are insanely difficult, and that's why like they're so crucial to learn with those Molly oriented characters, and why those Colby clutches coming in are so important, because there's so many spots you need to remember when you think about lineups.
Still waiting. Where are
Brandon
you?
Throws out his haunt.
Still waiting.
Ooh, is destroyed.
But that's big intel.
It is. As a fade main, I can tell you that.
Bring them down.
Right now, where it looks like the boys are still hard holding down sight. They don't know it's going to be a 5-man. Oh, yep. Here we go. All util coming out right now as we jump to Colby.
Ooh.
Not being picked off. He getting sandwiched, and now Brandon's going down as well. Now that is a 3v5 hard retake for the boys. Now it's just Sova and Jack finding one.
Ooh, Hawk goes out.
Getting a couple blinds right there. Oh, we got Xander back sight. Gamer TPing out. Still a 3v4. Not the best angle you want to be holding right now.
Oh, Xander unfortunately unable to find that raise. And unfortunately, defensive.
It is a pistol round, so
that they don't count.
That doesn't completely throw off the tempo that was set from, you know, the game before. However, the boys do want to stop it right now.
Amen.
Before we get into subsequent rounds, because this could be bad.
Pistol rounds, they don't count. They don't count. That's a warm up.
That's a let's get a feel for what kind of site we're playing on.
Exactly.
Let's get a feel for how we're doing.
And don't forget, now they know that was a hard push.
That was a hard push. These angles. Look, the dog coming out, snapping away.
Toxin's
Shorty. Toxin's coming up. And him the chance to reposition right there, but it looks like it's going to be a hard, hard A push.
Yeah, going to be forced to drop that wall.
Everyone is just holding their angles.
They're playing very patiently today.
Yes.
They typically play pretty patient.
Typically,
well,
but this
Xander,
is like a
Xander's
new level.
A little less patient.
Spotting the brim right there, taking the trade, but he does have the Spectre. This could be bad, but it looks like it's going to be almost a full rotate onto B again.
Still waiting.
High coming
out.
Still waiting.
Finding one.
But Brandon finding one.
Oh, Mason finds two.
Spike down B. 30 seconds left.
Mason finds three. Mason finds four.
Oh, unfortunately, unable to find that fifth.
So close, but now it's Jack in the back.
Spike planted.
With the Spectre, now just spraying. Brim smoke coming out.
Close rounds.
So close, but fantastic pistol round. From Mason, he finds two. And right there, the flash really helps out, finds two more. but just ever so missed that right click right there. Just didn't have enough health to be able to survive it right there.
Hate to see it. But it was still a wonderful play.
Still wonderful play.
Still something to applaud.
Very true.
This is also not a map that we've seen UMW play the best on.
That is very true. The boys have struggled a little in the past.
I'm a good shot. That's three.
One enemy remaining.
Trap destroyed.
Spike down A. Flawless.
These guns we use.
Again, more technical difficulties. Our mic was muted. but that was a wonderful round. Xander finding four.
Xander finding four.
Jack
right
finding
there.
The collateral? Is that not? No.
Very true, but.
What is it called?
The kill steal. Well, the elim steal.
The elim steal. No. I mean, like, when you get a elim through something.
Collateral.
That is a collateral?
That is a collateral.
Okay. I thought that only applied to if you had multiple players in a row, but oh well.
No. But it looks like it's going to be aggressive.
Ooh, aggressive. Very aggressive.
But Xander is going to go down because of it. Spraying through that smoke, but getting the orb. Zach,
Jack.
Give...
What?
What a risky play right there.
Colby playing quite defensive.
We have a 2-2 split onto both sides right now, but it looks like it's going to be a hard B push. Jack unable to find any, but he is going to go down because of it. But now it's just Brandon on B.
Spike
push.
Planted.
He's going to hard hold that angle, make sure. Ooh. But here comes the dog spotting him, but not getting the stun off.
Bring them
down. Brandon's got some dogs of his own.
Very true, but finds the Prowler on Chamber, but doesn't really blind him right there.
Smart move. That angle there.
They have to find. They have to make an aggressive move to retake. But Mason finds one that could be good in terms of momentum.
Unfortunately, Colby goes down.
Ah, unfortunate. That's just really difficult. You know, you have that 2-2 split, unable to truly retake the site, and they just held it down very, very well right there. But now we got Skyle on the side of UMW, but we also have. That Brimel on the side of BC.
They're going to have to take out that Brim really quick.
Stressful stuff. Very stressful stuff.
Indeed.
You know, UMW not doing too great in the second half. They've always struggled a little bit when it comes in terms of defense opposed to offense. But it looks like...
Well, specifically on this map.
Specifically on Bind. But,
which is interesting.
Yes. But it looks like right now... Still putting the work in.
Ooh. Xander getting out of there just in time.
But Mason is going to go down, and Xander is going to get picked up.
Ooh, hard and aggressive plays from BC.
Brandon going to find one. Xander going to find one, but Xander going to fall himself. Now it's a 3v2. You don't have heals. Trail's coming out. Spike is planted again.
I'll find you.
Ooh, that haunt being destroyed before it can do anything. Be pushing out.
Prowler coming out, not finding anyone. Dart coming out, trying to get some intel, but popping a little.
Unfortunately, Colby going down.
Difficult position right there for the boys.
It's getting risky here.
A little bit. But it looks like a timeout's coming on the side of UMW. So we're going to have a minute right here. So let's talk about this round a little bit.
Indeed.
How do you think UMW is playing with this kind of different comp we've seen from them? You know, Mason, not on the duelist. He's on the sky. And you know, Jack not on the KO we've been seeing him recently. So how do you make of that?
I think it's incredibly interesting. Sorry to use that word so often during this stream, but I mean, they're still playing well. They did excellent during the attack. However, it just doesn't seem to be working as well on defense.
Mm-hmm.
I still think they're playing well. I think the big issue is that BC is hard pushing every single site, and they're not afraid to rotate either.
No.
But they rotate entirely as a team, which is hard to defend against with only 2 to 3 people on the site.
Yes, I really do agree with you in that BC is keeping up their own tempo. They are really setting the pace for themselves, which is something UMW does really, really well themselves. And it's kind of taking them a little by surprise right now. They're not expecting BC to make these insane aggressive pushes on the site. They're not expecting them to just hard hold. They're, you know, UMW's in a bit more of a passive role, which is something we haven't really seen them be able to adapt into.
Here.
Again, already, as I say that, here comes the aggressive push. With Jack falling. Colby finding one. But now we have a 2v4 situation. And Xander going down, but now it's Colby in a 1v4.
Well, Colby was able to pick up that Vandal.
That is very true. That could be very big for him. But he only has Molly. He does not have ult right now.
Spike
and Bomb
planted.
Is going down.
Oh, it's always the moment you look away. We are tied up now here.
9-9. UMW has seemingly been...
Ooh, was that Xander or not?
UMW has been seemingly unable to break, you know, this momentum that Brooklyn has been pushing for them once they, you know, once they took on the defense position, which is, you know, normally we're the first to defend, so we're able to kind of get our bearings and then kind of bring it back when we get on offense, but now... Roles are reversed, and it looks like UMW is really suffering in that scenario.
Ooh, enemy Brim already popping ult.
But Mason is going down, and Xander is going to find
one
with the op. Getting spotted by the Sova ult, but it looks like he wants them to know where he is. Getting sprayed through the smoke right there, but not falling because of it. That's the Viper ult right there.
Ooh,
and there's
Brendan
the fatal
ult.
Getting so much intel, and the Sova drone going down. But it looks like it's going to be a hard rotate. There's Colby ready for it.
Ooh.
Spotting the heads.
Molly.
Here comes the Molly. Not finding anyone, but getting a little bit of damage. Sova finding two onto Brandon and Jack.
Colby popping smoke. Starts to push.
Spike planted.
Colby finds
one. Colby unable to find the seconds. Getting flashed.
That's a 1v3.
Xander's got an op.
In such a weak position right now.
Ooh.
Missing the flick on the Sova. But it looks like
Sova's
going to play way too aggressive.
So aggressive.
He's backing up far. He's just going to save it. He doesn't have...
It's likely for the best.
That is very true. He does not want that opposing Sova to get that op. But it looks like, you know... He's just going to let the... just gonna let the bomb explode. He's just gonna go to the next round, save that op, and just try to maintain the position.
Indeed.
Looks like UMW's really struggling right now, and it's looks like it's kind of difficult for them to really gain a bearing back on the rounds that they're losing.
Yeah. It's unfortunate to see.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely unfortunate to see. However, I still have full confidence that Our Eagles can bring this game back. Am I not talking loud?
Yeah, speak up.
Okay. I still have full confidence that our UMW Eagles can still bring this game back. I mean, Xander still got the op.
That is very true. Xander still has the op. And he also saved a little bit more credits from that round beforehand, finding 2 picks himself.
Ooh, Jack gonna sit in that wall.
But not finding anyone just yet. But it does look like it's going to be a very aggressive A push.
Bomb bot going
Jack out. Has the right idea right there.
if only he knew. He's just out of it.
Finding anyone?
Oh, finding one.
One is gonna go down.
Almost finding two.
Almost finding two. Always having to play such defensive angles right now. Not spotting anyone.
Last player standing.
Now it's Brandon in a difficult clutch scenario.
I mean, it's really hard to come back. The enemy team has such better ego.
Such better momentum. I mean, that raise is doing so much, getting so many picks, not only with the ult, but just creating so much space with the boom bot and the nade. It's really difficult, you know. UMW lacks that that kind of pressure.
Indeed. All right.
It looks like Brandon's pulling out the judge.
Judge Brandon. Ooh, that's a beautiful skin. I hope the enemy team isn't saying that that we'll win only if pigs can fly, because I see a flying pig right now.
Here comes the boombot, not spawning anyone, but going down.
Ooh.
Getting a little bit of intel for BC.
Ooh! Mason finding a pick through the smoke.
And Brandon finds one right there, but he tries to pull out the dog. He wasn't ready, but Mason finds a second.
One enemy remaining.
Oh! And a beautiful, beautiful defense from our UMW Eagles.
That was a nasty one tap. Mason, what was going through your head for that? What was that?
The pick what through was that? Smoke.
Insane stuff. Just, he knew. That was a soul read. There's no better way to explain that except a soul read.
He picked up the vibes.
That is very true. He's felt a disturbance in the force, and he took action. But it looks like Mason's going to go for a really aggressive push right now. He hears Sky. He hears Dog coming out.
Here
comes the flash.
Brandon going to throw out. Dog's on. And the Haunt taking out the boom bot.
He knows the push is coming. And Mason's going to find it onto a... Mason's going to find two.
Oh, two.
He finds two.
Three.
Mason finds three.
Four.
Mason finds
four.
Brandon taking that silver at the end there, but that's okay. That's all right, because that just tied it up for UMW. Mason, you're insane, brother.
Let's see that again. Takes out the dog. Pops flash. Brandon gets put in somewhat of a sticky situation.
Haunt,
takes out the boom bot.
But then right there, you could see the ult going off and Mason taking that battle. And then he takes the second. He takes the third. He takes the fourth. Boom. But now by the sounds of it, we're going to start playing.
Ooh, I know Jack heard that.
And it looks like he's 100% ready for it. Here comes the drone, spotting Jack, but not getting the scan off, getting the dart up.
Gonna try and fire through the wall,
but not finding a pick.
Mason checking B-long.
I'm just watching
this. I didn't even notice they did that.
I'm just watching this feed right now.
Ooh, Sander still has the op. Watching that angle hard.
Oh, trap goes down.
Watching the feed right now. Ooh.
Unfortunate trade.
Indeed, Mason's long range rotate, unfortunately.
That's a great idea, because now they know.
Checking a push, play a little bit more aggressive.
I've got your trail.
Does not work out, unfortunately. Ellie. On the dog. Oh, unfortunately goes out to that chamber ult. It's just Colby.
Left.
If the Colby clutch factor comes out, it's going to be the Colby clutch factor ace.
That is very true. But he knows now they're planting bait. And he hears that bomb.
Ray's playing ultra aggressive, but Colby taking him out.
Stim Beacon coming out, getting that enhanced fire rate right there, not finding anything. Pushing through the smoke.
Oh, unable to get the Sova.
That's just the difference from high ground to low ground right there. There's not much you can do in that situation.
Match point.
Here we are, match point of game one. Hopefully it won't be.
Hopefully not.
Hopefully not.
I am on the edge of my seat right now. UMW, this round is so crucial for them. Dropping, you know, if they can secure this round, they're able to, you know,
isolate them and play overtime.
Yeah, that is very true. And in overtime, we can see maybe a different scenario for them. But right now, have to play super smart.
No one found B long, so Xander's gonna pick that up.
Xander's ran through the smoke by not finding anyone. Dog coming out. Spotting the Sova drone, spotting Raze.
Mason taking out that.
Here comes the Sova ult. Not finding the first shot. Not finding a second shot.
We're watching Mason dance here. Oh, unfortunately, Mason goes down.
Jack not getting caught by that Sova shock. Not, and just getting nicked by that one, too.
Ooh, he's playing really defensive.
Stressful right now for UMW.
Poison's off.
Every angle matters. If you've ever heard the definition of a nail biter, this would be it right now. Ooh, Jack knows. He has an idea. Spraying right there and finding one pick. Now it's tied up again.
Oh.
But all the ults coming out. Colby going down. Brandon going down. Now Xander's forced to rotate. But Jack's kind of caught right there.
Oh, Jack unfortunately going down.
Here's the, but here's the chamber ult.
And unfortunately, Xander is taken out.
That was such a close map for UMW. I mean, they brought it till the very end on that one. And there's nothing more, you know, there's nothing more you can do. That was still a great game. The boys still played fantastic. You know, seeing Jack on that Viper, seeing Mason on that Sky, it looked like they were very comfortable with those picks. It didn't look like they were too out of their area. It looked like they still knew what they were doing.
Yeah.
And we just have to see, you know, what kind of comps they're going to do or if they're going to keep it and how they adapt to that in the future.
That's true. That's true. But, like we're going to be going to a quick ad break.
So we will see you when we come back for that. Don't leave. See you in a minute.
No, ready? Tell me when you're ready, anytime. Hello, I'm Troy Paino. We want you because students are at the heart of everything we do.
Okay, right here?
After the clamp?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, I got this.
Pete, you're bombing my thing. Clap it, and then we want you. Okay. We want you.
We want you.
We want you.
Alrighty, everybody, welcome back to game two of this set, UMW versus Brooklyn College. Now, if you're just joining us, sadly, the UMW boys did lose map one to Brooklyn College. However, it looks like we're going to be sitting in a bit more of a normal comp for these guys. We're going to see Jack back on the KO. We're going to see Mason back on the duelist. We're going to see Brandon. Oh, this looks like a normal comp for the boys right now. This looks like something they're used to. But, you know, it's going to be interesting to see Colby on the Omen. You know, Brandon still with the Sova. This is, like I said, more normal comp for these guys. More interesting, more, like, known play style. And, I mean, you know, BC on the other side right there looks kind of normal to them. However, they are going to trade out that Omen for a Brimstone for the smokes.
Select your agent.
Dang. So she's so sassy when she says it. Select your agent. Hurry up. Yeah, but it looks like right there. All right. There we go. All righty. This is going to be a very interesting map, too. I mean, you know, we've seen what the boys are able to do on Ascent. We've seen what they're, you know, what they're able to pull through. So it's going to be very... very interesting to see how these guys play. What are you excited to see?
I'm excited to see Mason.
That is
you
right.
You remember true. Mason last week? Oh or that God. Wasn't even last week. That was Friday.
Very true.
Mason Friday with that jet was a sight to behold.
He truly was.
It was one of the wonders of the world while he was playing. So I'm really excited to see his gameplay in this match. And I'm really excited to see Jack's gameplay as well. Jack was playing pretty good. Last game, he had nice lineups. He knew where to place himself. He narrowly escaped a Brimstone ult. I'm excited to see what they're going to do.
Yes, as am I. I'm very excited. I mean, you know, we're starting off on attack right now. So this is very different than what we're used to starting off on defense. But I mean, you know, the boys are going to be able to hopefully keep this momentum rolling right now. You know, taking map one does a lot to your mental, does a lot to that thinking game. So, if there's any team I know that's able to bounce back from it, it's going to be these guys.
Jack throwing out that knife and a flash.
Deep knife, but it looks like
aggressive push.
Chamber is going to pick off Xander right now.
Ooh, Mason unable to get the enemy jet.
But he sees him right there.
Oh.
And Colby backs him up. 2v2, and now
Mason
we're on site.
Mid. Unable to get that chamber, but Colby plants spike.
Colby's in a 2v1 right now. But it seems to me that that chamber
going out.
Chamber is out of chamber is out of
ooh. 2v1 taps to Sova.
He's a bit low himself, so he's got to play very carefully right now. Chamber TPing away, but getting a little damage tacked onto him.
Oh, and Colby is expecting the rotation.
He's got the right idea. He knows where he is
Chamber
right now.
Jumps down.
Ooh. Colby.
Oh, Colby clutch factor coming into the game.
In the pistol round.
Ugh. Good to see it.
The 4K, too.
4K?
That's insane.
Wonderful job, Colby. Beautiful.
And production's popping off just as much as we are right now.
Well, you love to see it. You love to see it.
You do love
this,
to see it.
You know, I think this round could probably reset them.
That is very true. I mean, right there, there's
or at
nothing.
At least they're mental. You
there's
know?
Nothing. There's nothing better as a viewer than watching the Colby Clutch Factor.
Oh, for sure.
I mean, like, that in and of itself is such a strong tool, like Ooh. I said, that UMW has. But it looked right there. Chamber.
Ooh, Jack already throwing out that
Chamber
flash.
Mid.
Oh,
Ooh.
Another.
Ooh. Immediately picking off Mason right there. That's huge for BC. But now it's going to be interesting to see how UMW plays this. Have a bit more momentum with the weapons.
Ooh, they're pushing hard.
Jack sees him right there, and he's got the right idea. He's got two above him in heaven while Jack's sitting nice in hell.
Ooh,
knife coming out.
Knife.
catching three, and they know exactly where they are.
Some wonderful plays by Jack this round. He's just gonna sit there, he's gonna wait. Brendan doing much the same over at that mid.
And Colby finds one, Colby finds two, and Brandon did a bit of a trade, and Brandon finding one, and now it's a 4v1.
Everyone watching hell, but Jack getting the final elim.
Oh my gosh, guys.
We said it once.
That's what I'm saying, Sage.
Ascent is these boys' map.
It really is. I mean, already they are starting off so strong on attack. They are pushing to site. They are keeping it held down no matter what. And already, like, they're just doing fantastic. Eco's up. Mental's up. Limbs are up. There's nothing more you can ask for.
Again, just beautiful to see. All right, Jack playing really aggressive with this KO. Oh, Mason unfortunately getting picked off again at the start of this round.
Mason taking a lot of these very aggressive fights, but Brandon has the right idea. He saw him.
Ooh. Brandon taking out that Sova.
And Brandon going down, but no damage tacked to him at all.
They're playing drone.
That's Brandon's huge. And now he has a Vandal in his possession.
Ooh. Knows where Chamber is.
Closing him off, but does he know that there's two UMW members right there? There goes his trip.
Ooh, but Xander unfortunately going down to the chamber. Colby as well going out to the chamber.
Brandon in a very sticky position right now. Oh, a little bit of a panic jump, and now it's Jack in a 4v1.
Jack grabbing the jet, picking up that Vandal.
Now this is really big for him. Jack does not have Spike, however, but he does have all the util he needs to take it back.
Yeah, he has a full kit. Missing knife. They know where he is,
but not detecting anyone.
You know, they know where, they likely know where he is, but he does not seem to care.
Ooh, no, Jack finds one.
Unable to find another. But still, another wonderful round.
Yeah, that's huge for UMW. I mean, that really supports their eco. They're still able to full buy going in the round four right now, you know, and still be able to sit pretty next round. But it's going to be kind of interesting. I mean, the enemy Sova lost his, you know, went down pretty early in that round. It's kind of difficult for them, but it looks like, yep.
Ooh.
There it is. Xander with the
Op God Xander.
But now, you know, Mason, he's got pick off first all three rounds. He's got to be play extremely carefully. But now yeah, enemy chamber has his own ult.
It's weird to see Mason. And
it is the start of the round, however.
Ooh.
Oh, Jack playing so risky right now.
Oh, giving Colby the spike. Likely for the best.
He's going for a way more aggressive play. The pop flash right there, not finding anyone. But the enemy chamber not faltering, staying exactly where he needs to. Looks like Jack's gonna make his way up mid right there. There goes Mason in a 3v1 situation. This is so stressful. It really is a game of chess right now.
Standing ahead.
Not finding anyone, but Mason falling to the enemy jet.
Brim Judge. Unfortunately, going down to the enemy Sova.
30 seconds left.
Xander getting pinged. Colby still has Spike.
So they are able to make a push to a site if they need. They gotta play super carefully. Not ready.
Oh, Colby finding him.
They're not gonna have time, but they really just have to save it right now.
10 seconds left.
Is Chamber gonna go for another quick pick? It looks like they're just going to play it safe and save. They're watching their backs. They're watching these angles, making sure no one falls. No more eliminations come out.
And that's likely for the best, because not only do they get to save the op, they get to save Colby's Phantom.
That is very true.
And I don't think either of them got hit either.
No.
Makes it much easier for them to buy.
Yeah, that makes it that is very true. But I mean, you know, UMW right now, looks like Colby's coming in with a bit more than just a clutch. It looks like he's coming in with a bit more of the Colby carry.
Ooh.
Sadly, Xander and Mason, two players who do very, very well, are just unable to find any eliminations right now. And already
throwing the knife,
going for a hard suppression. Frank through the smoke, not finding anyone. There goes the door. The smokes are still coming out.
Ooh,
and the bomb's going down.
Mason watching heaven.
For a hard setup right now. This is working out really well for UMW. Shots are just being fired, but no eliminations are being found.
That door went out.
Ooh.
Oh! Watch that door, unfortunately.
Not finding anyone just yet. Finding one. Jack finds one himself. Mason finds one. Mason finds two. Mason finds three. Mason coming back from the bottom to the top with a three-man clutch.
Wonderful clutch from Mason. That's enough to get your head back in the game. Wonderful discipline there. As you can see, Brandon finds the one, right?
Yep, pushes through the smoke. Same time Sova does, and they don't really find each other, but Jack backing up.
So here we are at Mason.
One.
He picks one. And look here. Doesn't fire. Completely waits. Unfortunately, it cuts off before you can see it. Another hard push here.
Look at this. Jack finds two. Immediately gaining control of sight right now. Now the boys know they have so much room to be able to play with. And now they see another one right there. Shock Dart coming out. Getting a bit more damage tacked on. There comes the drone. They still know where he is. This is insane intel for UMW. Dart coming out, finding a little bit more damage onto Chamber. However, Jack, a little low right now. Knife coming out. Not detecting anyone, but that just means that they have enough distance to be able to play with. Now the question is, Jack finds three, but Jack is going to fall.
Jack going down.
Same thing with Colby right
now. It's a 3v2.
But it looks like the boys are going to risk their life for this. Mason finds one. And Mason finds the last one right there as the boys trying to make their way as fast as they can off of sight.
These boys are playing like a well-oiled machine, let me tell you, folks.
They made it off safe. No, everyone who fell there fell. No weapons were lost. That saves huge for the eco. That saves huge with... That's just huge.
Insane round. Wow.
Well, wow indeed.
Wonderful plays from Jack getting those two early picks.
That is very true.
These incredibly aggressive plays seem to be working out.
Yeah, and I mean that Sova Dart from Brandon came in clutch for him too. Gave him all the intel they needed to be able to tell. But it looks like the jet arrows are coming out, finding one on the Xander, but that's okay, because now they know. Jack going.
Mason pushing hard with that jet.
While going down, and Brandon gonna find one onto the enemy Sova. Now they have sight control again. Chambers put in a difficult spot.
4v4 situation.
Brandon is gonna fall.
Unfortunately goes down.
KO. That's the enemy KO ult. Not being able to use abilities right now. That's okay.
All the UMW boys have to do though is delay.
Here comes the flash. Here comes the knife. Detecting two.
Ooh, Jack unfortunately going down.
Mason is gonna find one. And now it's a Colby in a 3v1.
Oh, and unfortunately that Kobe clutch factor can't come out.
Thrifty.
And the enemy team just barely able to defuse that spike.
That's very true, but the boys still have, they still have everything going in their favor right now. Not only on attack, but this, obviously this is their map. They still have a round up there. Eco is doing pretty well, and they still have, ults to spare. Although, Brooklyn... Has ults of their own.
Indeed.
Looks like they're going to go for more of another aggressive A. Just, the boys are not ready for it. continuously splitting. Oh, but here everyone comes, the back jack up. Knife out, not finding anyone, but now you're gonna have a three-man peek right there.
Ooh.
Xander finds Jet, that is huge.
They don't care if they're suppressed. They're gonna keep pushing anyways.
Nope.
That smoke going down. Enemy Brim.
And Mason still has those knives to be able to work with right now, but it looks like it's gonna be a full rotation because of that KO ult. Unable to really get anything on the site. But it looks like Jack's still gonna wanna pick a fight right now.
Jack does not care.
Jack does not care. He wants to take every fight he can at this point, and Mason's gonna stick there with him. For a bit of a fake rotate right now, not finding anything. Flash coming through. Colby dropping.
Jack unable to find the one up top. Ooh, that brimstone. Oh, Jack just barely surviving.
Now Jack's in a 2v1. He does not have bomb. He does not have anything to play with right now. And they could juggle peek him all he likes.
Oh.
He was put in such a difficult situation right there. But that's a lot of ults for Brooklyn gone right now. There go. Yeah. That was brimstone ult. That was what else was that? That was KO ult.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's a lot of crucial ultimates gone for Brooklyn. However, you know, UMW doesn't have that many to play with themselves. That was Mason's knives right there. So now the Jet ult for UMW is gone.
Mm-hmm. Just a quick thing. I just want to thank everyone in the chat for redeeming the Let's Go UMW and the Get Dirty Go Wash. Thank you for all of your support. And yes, this round is going to start. And another really aggressive B push.
We do have to give Brooklyn some credit, though. They have been doing a fantastic job of being able to stop UMW's momentum right now.
Ooh,
where they're able to keep it up
there.
So well. Mason finds one, but going down himself. The spray from a...
Oh, Jack unfortunately going down.
He was put in a difficult position.
Damn it. Not ready yet.
That's a typical position for Mason. But he does find
one. Oh, unfortunately going down.
But it's Colby.
Colby
finds one. Oh, so close. Colby found two right there. But sadly, there was just one more player he had to deal with. And, you know... Peeking away, just was not ready for it.
Both sides playing really well this game.
They really are. Like I said, UMW is doing a great job at being able to take sight, being able to keep up their own momentum, but Brooklyn's doing a fantastic job at regrouping themselves and being able to stop that momentum before it gets too crazy for them to be able to handle. It really does rile the stress in me watching these guys play and watching just plays like this happening.
Oh, Jack unfortunately getting picked off at the start from the enemy Jet.
But it looks like Mason's going to want to take a fight of his own. He's going to want to take a little battle right there.
Oh. They're just getting picked off one by one, but it's Colby and Brandon. We've seen the Z boys pull off some crazy shit, but let's see what. Oh, some crazy stuff, but let's see what Colby and Brandon can do. Oh, it's fine. People make mistakes.
But now it looks like UMW is going to be watching us see what mistakes Brooklyn makes. They're going to be able to take something right here. They do have bomb in their possession, but Colby does not have ult to be able to work with anything.
Blind,
not finding anyone.
30 seconds left.
Cover going out.
Looks like they can make an aggressive push back to their spawn.
Cover going out.
But finding one on the Sova. but they do have intel. They do know that they're rotating, and now they know that they're saving. So what is UMW going to, kind of position
left.
Is UMW going to take right here? Jet holding that hard angle with the op and not seeing anything. They're just
truly
saving.
A nail biter.
They're just saving. They don't want to lose these guns.
Alright.
It's just so stressful.
We have two rounds. Three? Two or three to the switch.
I believe it's two rounds to the switch.
Two rounds
to
the switch.
Now, this is very crucial for UMW. If they take this back, they can tie it up going to the second half right there. Or Brooklyn's gonna be able to keep a four round lead on UMW, which is gonna be very difficult
to
take back. Going
the chamber ult going out.
Yep, and the tech coming out. The silence, I'm sorry, on the Mason. He does not have any util to work with right now,
here.
But that's okay.
Seems like the boys are going to try and push A. They're going a little slower,
but it does look like Brandon has a lineup. He's got a good lineup for that dart right now. Trying to get as much info as they can.
Delayed push.
But Jack falling
a.
to the enemy KO.
L there.
And they heard that
gun
window
here.
Break.
Ooh.
That was a good TP out. Colby finding one.
Oh, Sander unable to grab them. Brandon unfortunately unable to.
Very difficult right there. Like I said, just Brooklyn has been doing such a fantastic job at just cutting UMW's momentum.
Last round,
they really
the
have
switch.
Been stuffing them out, which has just been insane for UMW right now.
Another
in terms of
going out.
In
yeah.
terms of being able to manage like just so many factors.
Indeed.
And it's insane what they're trying to do right now.
Brooklyn seems to be really good at retakes.
Yes. They've
wonderful at retaking. And while our boys can get on sight and they can take sight, it becomes difficult when you get aggressively pushed right after.
Yes.
Just want to say thank you, Teleg, for redeeming that Let's Go UMW. And I have to agree, we do need that Colby Clutch magic right about now.
That is very true. If we could get a couple Colby Clutch aces, that would be fantastic.
One after another, 1, 2, 3. Hey, Colby can do it.
Yeah. If there's any member, Colby can.
Ooh, what is that? Is that the Wise Mystical Tree?
Wise Mystical Tree. That could come in big clutch right now. If you guys want to support your UMW boys, yes, I'm doing this. Spam those Wise Mystical Trees in the chat.
Should make that one of our emotes. Wise Mystical Tree.
Wise Mystical Tree.
Ooh, we got another one.
Is that not one? Is that not one of our
no.
emotes?
No.
What is it from?
I have no idea.
Ooh. Oh, and chamber going down.
Ooh. That Brim all going out,
but not finding anything just yet.
Ooh,
oh,
Xander grabbing that pick off of Jet. They're gonna push.
Here.
But
playing
not
really
spotting.
Aggressive.
But not spotting Sova right there.
Mason gonna go down to Sova. Xander picking up the op.
Oh, there goes Brandon.
Oh, and there goes
now
Xander.
It's a 2v2. Brandon and Colby. But KO's hit a lot. All they need is just to look at him. Just breathe in his general direction, and KO can go down.
Ooh, Brandon finding one.
Can Brandon find one KO more to make
where?
It to three?
Ooh, and Colby ending it with a headshotty limb.
Oh, that is huge for UMW right there. 7-5. Brooklyn is up two rounds going into the switch. However, it's going to be very interesting to see how UMW is able to take this momentum back. They have
Indeed.
The round going into the switch. They have that energy. They have no frenzies, but that's okay. I saw Brandon with the frenzy, and then he immediately switched to the ghost. I was going to make a comment. Like, they have the frenzy. This is going to be great for them. But they
improvise, adapt, overcome.
That is very
true. Those CQB engagements don't seem to be working out for them this game. No more frenzy.
Excuse me.
Oh my God. I'm good.
Oh.
Oh.
Aggressive plays from Xander.
But he got all the intel he needs.
Exactly.
There goes Brandon falling. Ooh. Sprang through the smoke right there, taking the wall down.
Spike planted.
That is so stressful. They are looking directly at each other.
Oh!
And Mason takes him down with a headshot.
You mean Xander?
Xander, I am so sorry.
I love you, Xander.
Such a fool.
Ooh. Unfortunately, Xander.
Ooh, but Jack finds one. Trades his buddy.
Oh, Kobe going down.
Jack finds two. But sadly, Jack falls himself, giving the opposing Jet a 3K.
Hey, we saw a chamber duel.
That is very true.
Like the Wild West.
Yeah, and Xander came out victorious in it. However, he was unable to maintain that ground going into the next duel he picked for himself.
All right, let's see what is going to happen this round. This is a nail biter of a game, if I'm honest.
It really is. Shadow's traveling. Not coming out and not finding anyone. However, that is all the information they need. Xander finds one. However, Jack falls himself.
Super aggressive. Plays.
And the dart giving all the intel they still need. The shock dart coming out. Got their chamber finds two.
Oh,
Brandon.
Spike down A.
Oh. Mason, unfortunately, overcommitting.
That was an amazing just two tap from Brandon right there. However, there was not enough UMW members to back him up. The enemy KO got a really, really good spray with those Spectre right there, giving them the men up to be able to take UMW down in that fight.
Oh, that is a true wise mystical tree spam.
There's a wise mystical forest in our chat right now. Just great to see. However, Brooklyn is up four rounds.
Oh, no way.
Unable to find any.
Oh, unfortunately, Brandon goes down. They know they're there.
Xander going back. TPing out right there, not finding any. And just surviving. Jack finds one, though, but Xander falls in the back. Spraying through the smoke, not being able to find any more.
Spike planted.
Oh, unfortunate luck from all of our UMW boys around.
One enemy
except for Colby.
And now it's Colby and Jack in a
2v1
scenario.
And they clutch this out.
There's the flash. But now KO shut down. There's
KO
not much
D
he can
KO.
Do.
Oh! And a wonderful clutch by Jack.
Jack with the three-man clutch right there. Swinging the rounds back in UMW's favor. That's really big for them.
Well, the momentum.
The momentum.
They still have a three-round lead, unfortunately. But we're working on that.
We are working on that. But still, that's huge.
That is huge. It was beautiful to watch.
It really was. Now we just have to ask, how is UMW going to adapt to... You know, how's UMW going to be able to adapt to something like that?
Ooh, Judge Colby.
Judge Colby.
Love to see it. All right, Jack. That knife out. Xander playing mid.
Not
see that
getting
drone.
Spot and just TPing out.
Oh, Brandon sending his own drone out. We have drone
bit of intel
wars over here.
Still getting spot out. Brandon has a judge of his own.
Oh, we got two judges
holding these hard angles.
You think it's a circuit court?
Oh,
Xander
finds one.
Wonderful pick from Xander. Colby gonna hold that angle, waiting for the push.
Not finding anyone just yet. They're playing so patiently. No one wants to get spotted out. No one wants to fall.
Is a battle of attrition at the moment.
And Xander trying to make a little something happen right now.
Oh, unfortunately going down. Evening out the match.
30 seconds round. Left.
Brandon's got the right idea with that judge right now. Finding a great spray.
Not only getting a great spray, getting the spike.
But falling down right there. And now we're back at a 3v3 scenario. They don't have a lot of time right here. Jack falling himself. But they're just going to make it. Mason finds one. Now it's a 2v2 again. Mason finds another one. And Bomb is down. Spraying through. And Colby finds him.
Oh, another Colby clutch factor.
They played off of each other super well there.
The teamwork was just excellent.
It worked out super well. They played super safe, super patient, and it really just helped them in the end. It forced, you know, it forced Brooklyn to have to play fast, and UMW was able to adapt to that and take that round back.
In a war of attrition, the defender always wins.
That is very true.
Typically. Or else it wouldn't be a war of attrition. But anywho.
That works. Who will I spot first?
See Xander going for a bit of a normal setup right there. Both KO knives coming out.
Coming out. Pecking three already.
Spotting three and shutting
ult.
Everyone down. No jet knives either.
No jet knives. No ults.
Oh.
That was. Not comment on that.
Again, everyone playing so patiently, so safe right now. Mason not gonna find anyone, has the dash up. Is he gonna go for a quick peek maybe? Doesn't see anyone. Gonna dash back to safety. And again, everyone just playing safe, but they hear the util coming out. They know they're making a push. Ooh. Mason finds one, Mason finds two. But falling finally.
Oh.
Both jets find two, making it a 3v3 in that scenario. Colby gonna spray through.
Oh!
Gets found out just while he is reloading. That's very unfortunate.
Shot done.
Spike planted.
Oh!
And Brandon finds one.
One enemy
remains. Oh! The Silva ult coming out and finding.
Teleport's ready.
Right there. And now it's just a chamber v chamber battle. He hears him though. He hears him setting up. Going for a safe push right there. Xander's got the right idea.
Oh.
Spraying through. He still knows he's there. He's going to play for all the time he has in the world. But he doesn't have a lot left. He's going to stick it, but he just doesn't have enough. The enemy chamber playing so safe right there. He did not want, even for the couple frames he was on, Xander tried to make a play off of it, and it just sadly did not work in his favor. However, that was very smart from Xander.
Still a wonderful round. I hope this does not stop the UMW's momentum.
No. They had a lot going in their favor right there. So let's just see how they adapt. Again, how they adapt, improvise, and overcome in this scenario.
They can Bear Grylls it out.
Yes.
I can't do that.
Oh, the suppression.
And unable to TP out.
Brandon getting one. Brandon, unfortunately, unable to get a second.
Trades himself.
They're running the towards one backside. Can't really do much.
The knives are coming out. Dashing up, not seeing anyone.
Spike planted.
Getting one.
The single knife.
Pushing out. Close that, or open it.
Gets two. Finds two. Dashes out right there. He still has four knives to play with.
Oh,
almost finds three,
down.
But that's all the intel they need. Knife coming out. Colby finds one. And Jack finds the last one.
Wonderful round. Again, a wonderful round.
Oh my gosh. All right. These boys do look like they're having fun. They, regardless, you know, they still They still got a lot going for them right now. It looks like Brandon's going to go for another one of those cheeky little Sova dart spray kills.
Oh, yeah.
Elims. I'm sorry. Pardon me. But hopes to...
We all make mistakes.
Yes. But hopes to be able to find a really good pick for UMW right
blub,
now.
Blub, blub.
The blub, blub vandal coming out from Xander.
That Sova drone.
Not finding anyone. We'll be TPing to the other side.
Ooh,
double TPing out to safety, but getting spotted. Getting spotted by that Sova arrow. Could be big.
Ooh.
Xander, not going down just yet, but he does know that he's going to be engaging very soon.
Is that the battle you want to fight, Xander?
He's got this.
He's got blub. He's got blub blub.
He's got blub blub. He does have the blub blub boost.
Yo, that's great. We're all just playing really defensively, really slow.
Oh, Kobe finds
Kobe gonna
one.
Get one. Dancing around those.
Oh,
Xander finding one. Xander finding two. Only to TP away. Mason finding one. And it is a 5v1 situation.
What is Chamber gonna do in this scenario?
I think we all know does. Chamber's
he doesn't. He doesn't have Spike. Oh, now he has Spike.
30 seconds left.
But it looks like he's gonna start to make his way. However, Mason, he has the angle. They have all the angles covered. There's only one way that he can come from.
Ugh.
And the boys, they know he's ready for it. The crazy jiggle peeks right there.
Oh, beautiful.
A flawless round indeed from UMW. Oh.
No, don't say that. Sorry. No, not you, Jet.
Oh.
Did you hear what Jet said?
No.
It was one of Jet's very rude voice lines.
That is extremely toxic. However, the boys are playing a very honest game right now, taking fights super patiently. Now, this is what we were talking about. They're now adapting to, you know, the plays that Brooklyn is trying to make right now.
Indeed, and it is working out and paying off so well.
Will be hard backing off. He doesn't want to get spotted by that Sova drone again.
Ooh.
And here comes the TP back in, trying to engage, but getting spotted.
Unfortunately getting spotted.
That may be crucial info, however, it just looks like he's able to rotate off of it.
Yep. Hope he does not
care.
Goes
down.
Oh, unfortunately getting picked off, but now that's information. Jack
making an aggressive push.
Ooh, is Xander gonna close off that mid?
Doesn't spot anyone just yet, but Xander finds one.
Ooh, Mason.
They got an idea where he is, and Jack finds one.
Through the smoke.
Through the smoke.
And the
indeed.
Wall.
Indeed.
Ooh. Another planting.
Oh, they know where Jet is now. But it looks like they're going to be able to make a play off it. Spraying through the smoke, but not finding anyone. And you got all... Is that all for UMW up there? No, it looks like Jack's gonna rotate off. Spraying through, not finding anyone. Finding one long, TPing into a bad scenario though.
Enemy remaining.
Oh,
Jack's just gonna get half and able to get out with his life, and that's huge.
Last player standing.
This is less than ideal.
Well played by that enemy Brim.
Yeah, he had the lineup. He had the Molly and ult combo. There was just nothing they could have done in that scenario.
All right. Surely this won't kill UMW's momentum.
No, hopefully not. They still have a lot going for them right now, not only in terms of eco, but in terms of ults. You know, they're able to bring themselves back from this. Hopefully, we'll be able
to
see.
Oh, I know that's going to be nasty. I hate to.
So we don't carving out themselves. Not finding one just yet.
Oh.
And Xander TPing out, keeping himself alive.
Oh, but Xander finding one. Oh.
crazy battle right there, but Jack finds one.
Spike planted.
Oh, Kobe finds one. Begins to push. It's a 2v2.
It's a 2v2. No flashes.
Jack throws that knife. Sees if he can identify anyone. Doesn't seem.
Sprang through that wall. Not picking anything up yet. And here comes the Omen blind.
Stealing sight.
Oh, great thinking right there.
Oh, Jack unfortunately going out.
Finding one.
Oh, so close.
He's so low. One tap away. However, sadly, the right click just not being able to find it right there. Now, Brooklyn is one map away from being 2-0 over UMW. Now, this is a position we have not seen UMW in a while. But now let's clarify. This is a best to five. So, regardless, you know, UMW still has the opportunity to win the subsequent maps and bring this to either a game four, game five, which is, you know, very desired.
Ooh,
that's a four-man knife. Four-man shutdown right there.
Ooh, preemptively.
Cove drone to go out.
Oh! Wonderful play from the enemy jet, I won't even lie.
I didn't even know you could jump up that high, but it looks like Mason was very upset about that one.
I'd be upset too.
Ooh. Mason finds one, but gets traded for it. Kobe finds one.
Kobe finds two. Balancing it out. It's still a oh! As long as they can keep them away from the KO.
Oh, and they see him!
Oh, Kobe unable to get a third.
One enemy remaining.
Now it's just Xander versus this enemy chamber. He has the right idea right there. Hold it, trying to hold that hard angle. Oh,
he knows. Oh, and a beautiful clutch from Xander.
That was immaculate. Oh my gosh.
The flick,
okay, but I will also bring keeping it alive right there with the chamber deagle. Fantastic. Oh my
gosh. You can tell these boys have one thing on their mind, and it is that trophy.
Yes, very true.
All right.
Boys want to play so safe again. It looks like they're going to go immediately. The knife getting the hard shutdown. Finding out Xander's positioning, and he's able to make it out with his life.
But Mason gets one.
Mason gets one. Mason not finding another one. But Mason finds two. And Brandon finds one. But Xander is going to fall. Brandon finds...
Oh. Mason finding a third. A beautiful round. This dream is still alive.
Still going strong.
Those wise mystical trees in chat, we love to see it.
We love to see it. And thank you again. Let's just say right now, thank you everyone so much for sticking in the stream so far, supporting your UMW boys right here in the NECC Valorant Grand Finals.
This is a matchup I've ever seen one. Jack.
We've commentated a couple matches now.
Yeah.
But I'm sure we've been watching them all. And I think it's very easy for us to say.
No, I haven't been watching them. Actually.
I've been watching them all. And I think this is very easily to say. Regardless, this is the most exciting one out of all of them.
Oh, for sure.
I mean, these are the two best teams in their division right now, duking it out head-to-head in such a wonderful game. Xander just sees the leg of Jet right there. Trying to get a shot off, doesn't find an elimination from it though. But Jack is gonna fall.
Jack, unfortunately, as Jack just said.
Colby is gonna try to play super safe around these corners right now, not finding anyone just yet, but playing super patiently in order not to find anything. Oh, and finding the one tap. But now he knows where the rest of them are.
Blinding.
Stealing sights, doesn't find anything. The drone goes down.
You can blind the drone?
I did not know that.
You learn something new every day watching the UMW boys, I'll tell you what.
And the flash comes out, but Xander goes down as well. There comes the knife.
Oh, there goes Spike. KO.
Brandon with two.
Beautiful.
And now they're just going to hold Spike. They're gonna hold it close, make sure nothing comes of it. And not finding anyone.
Oh. Nail biter.
Out of charges.
One enemy.
Oh.
Mason grabbing one. Hey. And Kobe grabbing the other. The dream again.
And we are going into overtime. The boys need two rounds overtime to win in order to score this map. And if it goes 13-13, you gotta win to 15. 14-14, 16, and so on. But I think the most important thing is that they're going to be switching between defense and attacking. We're going to have to see how they're able to adapt in these scenarios.
Are we starting on attack or defense?
I believe we are starting on attack right now.
Works well for our boys.
Yes. So, those first 24 rounds, yeah. What are your thoughts?
I'm speechless. This has been the most anxiety-inducing game of Valorant I have ever watched, and I am loving every second, and I am excited to see more.
That is very true, especially in these overtime rounds. Every single elimination matters. Every single man still alive, kicking on the team matters the most, but it looks like these boys are going to be able to take something right there. Chamber not going down just yet, but not finding anything himself. The boy's hard pushing through the smoke. Ooh, and no one going down. Trying to spray through the smoke right now. Xander making his way on the site, and Colby finds him.
Jack knows where they are.
Mason finds two from spawn, and it's a 5v2 scenario. Jack, he knows exactly where they are. He doesn't need to go anywhere else. He can sit right here and make sure nothing goes wrong.
He's gonna use the knife anyways. He knows for sure.
For sure that Brimstone is in there. He knows for sure that he has to hold this angle.
They're just gonna hold it down.
And Colby finds the Opper. And now they know where Brimstone is, so it's really just about getting a pick. Brimstone finds one.
Colby getting that final pick.
Oh my gosh. Colby finds three right there to go up one round in overtime right now.
All right, now our boys just have to defend. Right, and let's see this second round in overtime brings for us.
Looks like the knife coming in, getting a five-man silence and a that Molly could have been crucial. However, that Sova Dart picking up so many right there. That's all five of them. They hear the jet dash, spraying through the smoke, not finding anyone just yet. The wall not going down. However, Jack falls, but Xander finds
getting
three.
Spike down.
Oh, unfortunately, unable to get the fourth.
Colby finds one.
And we have won game two.
That is 1-1 for UMW versus Brooklyn. Oh my gosh, I'm speechless. Please, Connor, find the words to describe that round for me.
The only way I know how to describe that round, the only way, is chaos.
That truly
beautiful,
was.
Beautiful chaos.
That was amazing. The boys played off of each other so well, and especially Xander with that three-piece solidifying the lead right there in that final overtime round. Oh my gosh. I think we popped off just as hard as the rest of the boys.
I honestly don't know what else to say. That was an insane match. I mean,
well,
wonderful gameplay.
Hopefully we'll be able to find some more words describing that last game right after this short break. Stick around. Don't go anywhere. We will see you then.
Thank you.
Hello and welcome back to this nail biter of a game. Sorry for that. We had a little mishap happen, but again, I'm your host Connor, joined by my wonderful analyst and host Jack. You want to say hello real quick?
Hello everybody. How are we doing? If you are just joining us now, we are 1-1 in a game 3 of a 5-game set against Brooklyn College right now. And I'm going crazy looking at this team comp. Like, look at this. We got Mason on the Sage. Okay, that's a new one. We got Jack on the KO. We got Xander on the Chamber. We got Brandon on the Sova. Great. Yeah. But Colby on the Viper is something new. And I think I didn't react crazy enough with Mason on
Sage.
The Sage. Not a pick I see a lot. And I mean, hey, it looks like... It looks like Brooklyn's responding with a bit of themselves, except without the KO, maybe opting more for the Jet. I mean, the Jet is really working wonders. Kira on the Jet and Noodle on the Chamber is just working out so well for them.
Well, I will say, Mason was playing Sky earlier.
That is
another character with heals, and Sage is kind of necessary in Icebox, if we're being honest. But I'm excited to see how our boys keep this momentum. It's going to be a difficult match.
Yes.
Overall. If only because you got to keep your wits about you. And again, thank you all for redeeming the Let's Go UMW and Get Dirty, Go Wash.
Yeah.
We love the support.
Yes.
Love to see it.
Thank you for tuning out tonight, especially on this late night. Tuning in tonight on this first finals night, we hope here at in the UMW Esports Lounge, both us commentators and our production team, is, you know, that all your finals are going well for you. But we are starting off on attack on Icebox. Now, it's going to be interesting to see how the boys in this scenario adapt. I mean, Icebox, it's a very interesting map. I mean, clearly seen in a lot of their clips and a lot of highlight reels for these players. So I'm very excited to see what they are able to do in a scenario like this. But it looks like the boys are going to have a lot more comfort picks.
Oh, yeah.
And, I mean, Mason's been doing phenomenal.
All game.
With all of these new picks. Not finding anyone yet, but you do hear shots for a trade, possibly. But no eliminations coming out just yet. No one falling in this scenario.
Looks like boys are gonna push up on E.
Ooh, there's Sova arrow.
Classic Icebox play, putting down that Sage wall. Need to plant right after. Cut them off.
Not
gonna rotate.
Oh,
ooh.
But that is two. Brooklyn right gonna find two from UMW.
Oh,
that is Brandon gonna be going down.
It seems
stick.
The tactic has backfired for them.
Oh, that's difficult. Blocking themselves off with the Sage wall just left such a hard angle for them to try to push. There's nothing that they really could have done in that scenario for them.
Indeed. But again, pistol round. Nothing to get too worked up over. Should be all right.
See how it works out for them.
Is that a full save?
It looks like it is going to be a full save.
Likely for the best.
And obviously a tried and true Viper wall right there. That's just the Viper wall. You know, you got to know as a Viper.
Ooh. Xander unfortunately getting picked off by that Viper. Ooh. Everyone going down one by one.
It was just econ over a save. There's nothing you really could have done in that scenario. They were trying to full save for obviously. Now they're going all Vandals, looks like. That's just rough for them. I mean, like, how do you come back? You know, 2-round deficit, that's okay. There's the comeback right there. And they're going to save those weapons. So obviously now you have the buff of weapons going into round 3. But how is UMW going to be able to make a change in this scenario right now?
Well, first, they can start by not attacking B. Does not seem to be going on.
That is Very true, but it looks like they're gonna have that smoke off. Both Sova shocks coming out, not finding anyone, making the slow push on the A site.
Brandon to see if he can get any picks whatsoever.
No, but it looks like they're gonna hard rotate off. Brandon not finding anyone just yet.
Oh,
perfect.
But trading Mason for the jet right there, same thing. Now it is a 2v3. Colby. And Brandon finding another one. That's a 2v2. Wall going up. Chamber and Sova. What can they do right now? Brandon gonna make the aggressive push.
Oh, beautiful.
With the three piece. And Colby going for the plant. Now they have an idea of where Chamber could be. Holding these hard angles. They do have the Vandals to be able to make plays, but they hear him. Shock arrow coming out, not finding any damage.
Ooh, what an aggressive line.
Oh,
beautiful round. And these boys just did not let the last two rounds get to them.
No, that was a fantastic three-piece for Brandon right there. That is exactly what they needed to keep that going right there.
Indeed, indeed. And now they're starting to adjust. Mm-hmm. They're starting to adjust to how BC is playing. BC is playing very, very aggressive on this Icebox defense. Something I'm personally not accustomed to seeing.
Yeah, but I mean, look at there. They look very comfortable regardless of the push. Brandon, he heard the Sova drone come out, and he knew the Viper wall was there. So he was ready to make a full push through that wall to solidify the elimination right there and secure the 2v1, but it looks like...
Ooh, Brandon going down from a chamber op, unfortunately.
That's just difficult right there. I mean, the op is a one-shot. Flash coming out. I don't think they found anyone.
Oh, Jack taking out that op.
Jack
really pre-firing those angles. We love to see it. Right. Well, up top. Unfortunately, Xander goes down, but Jack picks off the jet. And there goes the top contributors, the elims on the enemy team.
Now, that was just a little interesting interaction right there because, I mean, you're not really noticing that stuff.
Oh, unfortunately.
But there's Mason. He's ready for that.
Oh,
that's just a difficult position to be in right there.
Indeed, indeed. That's okay. That's okay.
I mean, Viper's just holding these angles really, really, really well for herself. Jag did have a pretty good round right there, getting rid of that chamber off.
Oh, yeah.
So that's really takes a really big hit into the eco of Brooklyn. But now, UMW, it looks like it's going to be a full save. But Brandon has the Marshall right now. Maybe going to find a little pick of himself. A little pick to himself.
There's it.
Not finding anyone just yet, but now it's going to be
a very aggressive push.
Jack with the shorty. Oh, he sees him, but he TPs away. And Xander finds one. But Xander goes down.
Ooh, Mason finding one.
Knives coming out, but
Mason
now there's the
Vandal.
Unfortunate right there.
Oh,
Mason finds three, and now it's Jack with the shorty.
Oh.
That was just gun v gun right there. There's nothing he really could have done.
That was just distance.
Mm-hmm. And Viper played it really, really well. Being the last one alive, making sure she's the one who clutches out the round for Brooklyn.
An aggressive defense on Icebox can really, really shut down an attacking team. I'll tell you what.
So many cracks and crevices to hide for...
Oh, yeah.
For just those cheeky picks, cheeky kills, eliminations, I apologize. But
it's like New York City.
Just corridors and alleyways everywhere. You just got to make sure to check each one to make sure you are safe. Sight of a beautiful, the beautiful skyline above Icebox right there. But it looks like it's a Sova dart on both sides, picking up one. Sage having to rotate off, but the wall's up.
Ooh, they're just gonna destroy the wall this time. They're gonna push. Oh, Jack unfortunately going down, but Xander finding the Sage. Ooh, Xander finding the jet. Mason rising Jack. Jack is not down yet. Ooh, now they know. Brandon goes down to the Viper, but now they know the Viper is there. Jack watching that angle, suppressing with that knife. Ooh. Doing the safe thing and just...
One enemy remaining.
Ooh. Hitting around. Oh, beautiful.
Oh! That's an ace?
That's an ace!
I didn't even realize it.
A beautiful ace from Xander.
Oh my gosh.
I didn't even notice.
I couldn't say. I was taken...
I was so absorbed.
I was so...
What was going on? I had no idea. Beautiful job, Xander.
Oh my gosh.
Us casters love you. Our op god.
Our op god turned Phantom Menace.
The low-key Star Wars pun. Oh yeah. Thank you for taking the bow with that one. You deserve it. Xander playing aggressive and finding a pick so early.
Is he gonna find a second one? Xander pushing such an advantage right now. Viper wall coming up. Giving some distance for UMW to play off of right now.
Xander trying to watch all those nooks and crannies. But do you think Timmy and Tommy work there?
He hears. He knows.
Oh, goodbye, Viper. And goodbye, Sage.
Now it's a 4v1 again.
Let's see.
Chambers got the ult for himself. They know where he is.
No way. No way. Is it gonna happen? Oh. That's fine. That's fine.
Unfortunate right there. Unable to see the back-to-back aces. But Xander with a 9 elimination streak.
Oh my god. Can he keep it going? Can he keep it going?
This man can't be stopped.
He really called him the Phantom Menace, and his inner Darth Maul came out.
Oh my gosh. Dragon left and right. Xander making sure he makes up for that Ascent game right there.
Oh, yeah.
Obviously, he was like, the bottom of the leaderboard is not a place I want to be. I need to be at the top. I want to be the carry for my team, leading them to victory. And he's really pulling that through right now. Not finding anything just yet.
Jack throwing down that fragmentation grenade.
And Xander finds another one.
It's a 10 elim streak. We'll be going down.
And the wall coming up.
Ooh, Jack going down. Wall goes up. Get out of that molly.
Looks like it's going to be a 3v4 for the boys right now. Mason finds one. Ooh. Xander finds two. Xander finds three. Looks like he's gonna tap it. Is he gonna hold it? No, he gets half. And now it's just a 1v1 chamber v chamber duel again. It looks like he's gonna go for it. Just tapping it, making sure nothing happens.
Oh! Oh my god!
Xander
cannot be stopped!
Xander! What is going on? He's on another level. He's on a different plane of thinking. There is no words that are able to describe the play that Xander is putting to the table right now. And it's tied up. It's 4-4.
Xander was sick and tired of being pushed around.
He's setting his own pace. He doesn't, you know, even if he's like, I want to lead my team to victory, if I have to put them on my back, I will. But now that's... two four-mans in a row and an ace. Xander, I mean, what more? There's nothing more that you
have
ask
to send
for.
Me your training routine, Xander. This is just ridiculous.
Those hard bots are really coming in handy right now, but now, getting spotted out by Jet, but not finding anything, and the heal coming out, making sure he stays healthy. But Jet being found out, sticking in.
Oh, Colby defending Xander,
making sure he's nice and good.
Jack finding two Jack picks finding while two? We're talking?
I mean, so far, we're not even able to take a break. I'm drinking. I take a sip of water. Xander finds an ace. We're talking about, we're talking about the ace. Xander finds a 4K. We're talking about the 4K. Xander finds another 4K. Like, what are you doing? Now Mason finds one.
And Colby closing out the round. This is some beautiful gameplay. Just the pure efficiency.
I mean,
they are sick and tired of being pushed around by that chamber and by that jet.
Now see, Connor, mm-hmm. I'm an English major.
All right, all
words right. Words are my style.
Yeah.
There are no words that explain how the team is playing right now.
I, as a published poet, I feel that. And you know BC is not taking this well.
Right there.
They instantaneously find a path through that sage wall.
But that's all the intel they need. That's all the intel they need. Sage, that wall being destroyed.
Go. Hard push.
Is she gonna come for a pick right there?
Oh.
Spike down B.
Right there.
Oh, and there goes the streak.
Finally goes down. But Mason finds one, immediately turning. Not seeing. Oh. He finds two. Unable to flick up fast enough to find three, but still
a wonderful, still wonderful, wonderful, honestly. But considering the situation, Mason, that was fun.
Yes, that was very, very. That round, though.
I'm sorry, Stream. I need to take a second to just...
But that round for Brooklyn was so important. That was the cut for UMW's momentum. That was the stopping point, and now it is very important for Brooklyn to see what they are going to be able to do. And the Sage Wall is up again, trying to get as much intel as they can. However, Xander finds one, and Colby finds the other! The Z-Boys taking down the two top fraggers for Brooklyn. And the Z-Boys are back at it again.
They make it look so easy. Gosh. Watch the flank here.
Getting risen up by that wall. Living through that viper, that snake bite right there.
The gusto it takes to plant a spike in a molly.
Here.
Finding anything just yet.
Take,
but it is a 5v3 scenario. You hear the footsteps. You know the push is coming soon.
Oh, Mason unfortunately going down.
And Xander finds one.
Xander is there.
And Colby finds the other one.
The Z-Boys again.
The Z-Boys are back.
And I mean, Colby was MVP last game.
He really was. And now Xander's like, you know what? I'm going to be up there, too. I'm going to be with my Z brother, making sure that we are holding down the UMW fort. But now this round is very crucial. Is UMW going to be able to take the two round lead going into the round swap?
Well, we do have three ults.
Or is Brooklyn going to be able to swing it back in their favor?
True.
Connor, cannot wait and see. I'm on the edge of my seat. Literally and figuratively. That's very big. The Colby finds one already! And they'll come out and Brandon finds another one!
Colby popping the ult, finding another! Oh my god. Oh! Jack accidentally taking out Xander. Mason picking Xander back up.
And Colby goes down. There goes the ult. Have not planted just yet. Oh, but he's
Mason plant.
One enemy remaining.
And that's Mason finding one. And that's Mason finding two. Going two rounds up into the half. 7-5. The boys are looking like they're doing wonders right now.
All right, they're gonna call timeout real quick.
Connor, give me a lowdown.
What is going through your head right now?
I find it hard to breathe right now. I am absolutely speechless. This is a breathtaking performance from our UMW Eagles tonight. As I said earlier, you can really tell that the only thing on these boys' mind is that trophy.
Xander, putting on a show. And not only that,
oh my
Colby
God.
Backing him up in those later rounds right there, making sure that UMW as a team, not only do they physically stay together, but that their mentality is one. They are playing on such a different level than what they have to the rest of the season right now, keeping each other in line, keeping, this is just amazing.
I have to give it to Mason. He's utilizing those reses to keep the pushes going. He's picking up Jack,
really
he's picking
is.
Up Xander. He's picking up whoever he needs to when he can to just keep that momentum and keep that advantage. So we're gonna go into the next half here. Another pistol round, but this time our UMW boys are gonna be defending. And surely they have this in the bag.
They really do. I mean, again, without the duelist, you do have a lot more pre-setup to be able to work with. You have a lot more util to be able to work off of, which is something that UNW does really, really well. And we're just going to see how they handle it right now.
Good angle play from Colby. Xander playing sneaky so it doesn't discover him.
They found my trap.
Ooh, getting one pick off with that Sage.
What a flick. Look at the
Godspeed,
flick of the wrist.
Godspeed, Sage. Godspeed indeed on your way to heaven.
Always yeah. 8 with the question in the chat. Is this a best of 3? No,
this is a best of five. Ooh.
With our other maps after this one,
one after another, Mason, picking up that ghost.
With our other maps after this one, we'll have, obviously, the second half of Icebox. We will have Haven, and then Fracture, if this is brought to a game 5.
Ooh, not a Kobe 4K there, but that's okay.
It is still a 4v1 right now. UW has total control of sight. Viper is back to the wall.
Ooh, both Z-Boys unfortunately going down, but Jack confirming that the Viper is down. I also want to apologize for that statement I made towards Godspeed Sage. Sorry for using your name to kind of roast a little. You are playing wonderfully. Yes.
I mean, both
you could dog me any day.
Both teams in this match have been playing off the charts on a level that I don't think they themselves have been able to see. Like, and it's just fantastic watching this kind of stuff. Period. I don't have a follow-up to that statement. It's just amazing watching these guys play in their element, in their game.
Colby knows they're there.
And is Colby going to be ready?
Spike planted.
Now, how patiently is he going to play right now? Jen is holding a bit of a cheeky angle right now, going for the hard push, getting the right click.
Last player standing.
Still a wonderful round.
Very difficult scenario to back themselves into. Such an aggressive push.
How did Mason not go down earlier?
I have no idea. I mean, there's just so many questions being unanswered that are just in this round right now. I mean, it's ridiculous. Like I said, both teams are just playing phenomenally.
You can really tell that both of them have entered that flow state. They're probably not even aware of just everything that's going on in their own heads.
Nope, rounds are just happening. Eliminations are just coming left and right, and they're just adapting to it. This is like nothing new to them. This is just another day, but Mason picking up 2 already.
Last player standing.
Now it's Xander in a 2v1.
Planted.
He saw Viper, but now he knows where Sage is gonna be, and he gets a one tap. Bit of a difficult position for him to be in. Now he does have the Spectre. And a little unlucky spray right there.
I don't know if I can keep doing this, if the boys are gonna keep playing.
My heart aches watching these guys play. Every single round being brought down to a nail biter scenario. Oh my gosh. But while we're just taking a minute here, let's just remind the chat. Hydrate. You know, it's important.
Hydrate or...
Eliminate.
Or be eliminated, dudes.
Yeah.
You need water.
Silver Drone coming, getting his hand onto Xander right now and snapping out of there, making sure he stays healthy. There comes the Viper wall.
Through the wall. Really unfortunate to see.
But Colby finds one. There's Colby's ult. Just like that.
4v4 scenario.
Thank you, Ivy Jenna, for the follow and supporting your fellow Eagles tonight.
Standing ahead.
Ooh.
That's very smart right from here. Brandon, recognizing the rotate is coming out and making sure.
Honestly, smart play by
Colby. Colby's just hiding in the smoke. And look at Mason.
Also being a sitting little sneaky and little goober. Mason.
Oh, Colby is ready.
Yeah, he is.
Molly coming out. They only have 20 seconds to play with right now, but he's got a good
idea where they are. Colby was born for this moment.
He's got a third. Unfortunate, but it is a 1v3. Brandon, where are you looking, buddy?
Nah, that was valid. Yep. Mason going to secure that round.
How'd Brandon not go down?
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, let's see that again. Obviously, Mason found the one, and boom, right there. That was a search and destroy, and then beautiful crosshair placement for Colby. He was prepared. There's nothing more to say.
Yeah.
He was prepared. He knew exactly what needed to be executed, and he just did it to such a professional degree.
You think he'd be studying that for his finals?
That is very true.
Get out of my way!
Knife coming out, not detecting anyone. However,
standing ahead.
Sova Dart picking up Jet, but not getting any damage tacked onto her. The knives are out though.
They know about that Jet ult.
Finds two.
Ready for it.
Shock Dart coming out, not finding anyone.
Oh. That Jet wasting not one, but three knives. Still not getting a single hit.
Nope.
Ooh.
And that's Xander playing... going down.
Ooh, unfortunate.
What an aggressive push from Mason, but not getting rewarded for it. Going down to Viper. Same thing with Jack, but Brandon, that's one for him. And now it's a Colby clutch, possibly. Getting all the intel he needs, and that's one.
Here comes the plant. Spike planted. We're on the opposite site.
Now this this is really difficult for Colby right now.
Hey, there's a reason we call it the Colby clutch factor. Ooh, getting another one. Still at full health. Hasn't even been so much as looked at.
And a singular snake bite. He does have time to play with.
He knows they know where he is. He's pushing hard. Watching all of his corners. He knows where they are now.
That's a little unfortunate spray right there. However, that could have been rewarded greatly.
Honestly, he played it
phenomenally.
That textbook example of what you're supposed to do. Just unfortunate with the shots, really.
Yeah, very much so. But it looks like the boys still have a very good handle on how the rounds are rolling in right now. Being able to maintain this control that they've had so dominantly in the attacking rounds.
Even when they lose the round, they still give them a good fight.
But it looks like it's going to be a pretty major save coming out from UMW. And that's...
interesting to see. Xander's got his ult.
That is very true. Colby is just playing as safe as he can.
Xander's just watching.
He knew. Oh, and Xander finds one.
Fortunately, it is not that.
Colby making the hard push.
Oh.
Not being found out just yet. Ooh. Sneaking right under that Jet's nose, but she was ready for it. Oh,
unfortunate.
Great thought process right there.
Oh.
And now it's Brandon. Spike finding planted. A Vandal in a 1v4 scenario.
Now here's the question, Jack. I didn't even get to ask the question.
Oh.
Okay, it is tied up now.
9-9. Four rounds needed on both sides to end this game, but UMW is looking like they're just faltering a little bit to Brooklyn's pace setting. It looks like now Brooklyn's kind of getting an idea of how UMW wants to play around
exactly.
This map, and they're adapting to it really, really well.
I will say this is around the time last match where UMW started to adapt.
That is very true. So let's see if they're possibly going to be able to bring out some of those tactics right now. To send this map into their own bag.
With their shots, they instantly know to rotate. Also, furthermore, BC might start getting cocky.
That is
they
very.
Might start getting a little bit of a bigger ego, and that might cause them to play differently.
That is very true. Jack does have the KO ult, so that could be very useful in shutting down. Possibly a Jet ult, but it looks like he's not going to find anyone just yet. Making sure he pushes up super carefully right now.
Spotting
Sage right there and ulting to give himself some space to play with. Boys rotating back. Xander is going to fall, but Colby is going to find one and he's going to fall himself. Now and again, it is a 3v3 scenario. Ooh. Aw.
Jack unfortunately falling, but that means they know where that Viper is. Mason having some fun right there.
Mason finds one, getting the res off. Again, it's now a 2v2.
Left. Xander back up.
Ooh.
Last standing.
That's an unfortunate res right there.
Oh! What an aggressive spray.
That was just luck.
Honest.
You know, Riot did say it was a very skill-based system. However, there's always a little luck in it.
There's always a little luck involved.
And Noodle just cashed out all those luck tokens right there for that shot.
He maxed out his luck stat. If we're going by Fallout New Vegas.
Now let's see how UMW... suppressive. Takes that back. Jack not finding anyone with a knife. Oh, but he's got the Bucky.
Toxins going up.
And now it's UMW, ooh, the one who's holding the little cheeky angles. Looks like they're not needed. It's going to be a full push onto A.
Oh,
Brandon not finding anyone with that. Mason getting sprayed and finding one.
Oh, almost finding two.
Stage wall right there.
Oh.
Now it is Jack in a 1v4 scenario. It's the Bucky. Not finding anyone with that knife, but that does kind of give away his position right there. Very patiently.
flashbang.
Oh! Grab that Vandal.
Is he gonna be able to find another?
Oh!
And he finds two. It's not enough time to defuse, but hopefully he's able to find another elimination from it. He's gonna run through mid, hopefully not get spotted. Is he gonna take that? He is!
Ah.
That last one, not finding anyone just there, but now it is two rounds up.
And Xander has an op.
Two rounds up for Brooklyn. This is incredibly stressful for UMW. They have been unable to break this four-round momentum Brooklyn has had so far, so we just have to see.
It's hard to breathe in this arena.
It really is. Everything.
You want to play?
The tension
Let's
is so
play.
High.
Oh!
Oh, Xander just missing the flick right there.
He did not care about that.
Nope. He wants that elimination.
That Elo.
Oh, but Mason sees the heads. And Colby
Ooh,
is gonna
Colby
fall.
Going down.
Oh.
Oh!
Xander!
Beautiful elim from Xander.
Brandon right there. Oh, he's got the right idea. He hears a...
Oh! Oh, whoa.
Getting the trade.
What skin is that? That made a cool sound.
That is the, that's the Nerf gun.
Oh, let's go! The Hunter.
Not spotting anyone. The ult. Gonna tack a little bit of damage onto Sage, but get the res off. He's gonna find one, but it is a 2v4 scenario again.
Oh,
that's just unfortunate.
An unfortunate turn of events, and unfortunately, Xander is not able to get there fast.
Match point.
Still wonderful gameplay. Again, he did take it to overtime last time. All it takes is a little adapting, a little improvising, and a lot of overcoming.
Yes.
You have to overcome your own mental. You have to overcome their momentum.
That's finds two with the knife right there. So now it's just playing patient and waiting.
Ooh.
Xander saw him. But now they have to make the aggressive push. Getting the dash, but TPing out of there to safety.
Oh, unfortunately going down. Right in there, however. Wonderful patience.
Planted.
Oh!
Great spray from Jack right there, finding the Sage. That's so crucial.
Ooh.
Now it's just the Molly on bomb, waiting for it to go away.
And
getting
that,
that
is the round. Ugh. See, the one thing about our UMW boys tonight is they keep making these clutch scenarios possible. They are fueled by nothing but their hopes and dreams.
And caffeine.
And
lots
caffeine.
And lots
yeah,
of caffeine.
Yeah, I think we all are fueled by a lot of caffeine right now.
Yeah.
It's the only thing keeping me awake.
That is very, very true. However, it does, the only ult on the side of Brooklyn is that Silva ult.
Ooh.
So.
But Kobe's got the, then?
Yeah.
Ah, yes. See, I'm smart.
And Brandon's got the judge.
Brandon.
He's just gonna hold that angle because he knows they've been aggressively pushing.
Ooh. I like the angle Jack is holding.
We're gonna be able to see traps to that right now.
Oh.
Oh.
Now they know.
Oh. Brandon having Brandon. To hard rotate away. He has to run. All he has is a judge. He can't take these long range battles. But that's Colby going
unfortunately
down.
Going down. That means no Vipers to end this round.
And Mason saw the jet right there. So that angle's given away. But it looks like she's going to still hold it.
Standing. Spike down B.
Mason's going to have to clutch. That's
my
one.
He does have res now.
Spike planted.
Looks like he's going to push back maybe. Try to go for a different angle. Go for a res.
Ooh.
And there's Colby.
And there's that Vipers dead back.
Now they have to make haste. They have to get
nice,
on the site.
Nice pre-firing here.
Slow comes out. Viper ult.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, now it's just how you take those trades, and there's the Sova ult right there. Sadly, there's nothing UMW is able to do in this position right now, and that is going to be map 3 going to Brooklyn College. They are up 2-1 against UMW. We're going into map 4. Haven, Connor, what do you take of that game?
It's so hard to breathe in this room, Jack. I'm going to need to get my inhaler. But ultimately, it was a great game. There were a number of wonderful clutches. I mean, we saw Xander's first on-stream ace.
We saw, and then the 2 4Ks following that, which was
beautiful
insane. Playing.
Insane. And honestly, I think they might have Haven in the bag.
They really do.
We just got to hope that, you know, our boys take this to Fracture.
Mm-hmm. I'm hoping to see a game 4 and game 5, but honestly, this is the most tense match, I think, of Valorant I've seen ever. And it just keeps going and going. But don't go anywhere. Game 4 is coming soon.
Stay. We'll be right back. Stay frosted.
Thank you. Hey, Kira, can you swap sides?
Sorry, I didn't realize.
No worries, thank you.
Alrighty, everybody, welcome back. If you were just joining us, hello, my name is Jack. I am your wonderful analyst and co-caster tonight, and I'm here joined with my wonderful caster, Connor.
Hi, how you doing?
And now, Connor, UMW's in a tight spot.
We are
2-1 going into game four of this five-game series, and now we are defending on Haven, but I think the most interesting thing is if you look at our fade, we have a bit of a sub right now. We have Charlie stepping in for Brandon.
Yeah.
Big man Charlie.
We haven't seen Charlie since what?
No, we haven't commentated.
We haven't commentated Charlie. We haven't commentated a game with Charlie, but we haven't seen Charlie play since the beginning of the season.
It's going to be very interesting to see how he plays, but it looks like UMW is taking a more traditional stance on their comp. Again, you have Mason on the duelist, and you have Jack on the KO. You have Xander on the chamber. You have Colby on the omen, and you do have Charlie on the fade. But it looks like, on the side of Brooklyn College, we're going to see Godspeed, who's normally been playing like that more KO-oriented role on a Breach. Very interesting.
Well, looks, still an initiator.
Very true, but it looks like they're going to try to take a very aggressive push towards site right now. They're going to want to take it, hold it, and make sure they keep it. But obviously, UMW starting on the defense side, they're going to have a little more leeway to work with. Personally, I'm not a fan of Haven. I don't like the management of three sites. However, I know it is a favorite among some of the guys right now.
It's not a favorite amongst me either, I'll be honest.
No, but we will see.
I'm excited to see how Charlie plays. I actually got English for Charlie.
Very,
Wow. Well, dude. We didn't figure it out until, like, the end of the match.
Very true. But I...
But no, I understand where you're at, Jack. I just... Ooh. Yeah, it's a... Okay. I mean, it's been really, really hard to breathe.
That is
after these past couple matches. Ooh. Wonderful haunt from Charlie. And they're pushing.
And Charlie gets one.
One.
And Xander finds one for himself. And then Mason finds one. And now it's a 3v2, but they know where they are. Charlie going for the defuse right there.
Defuse.
He's got both of his teammates on his back. And they're body blocking for him, making sure he stays alive. And he sticks it!
Wonderful. All right. What a wonderful round.
What a wonderful first round indeed. Very exciting. I mean, especially, like I said, very exciting to see what Charlie is going to be able to do on this fade. I have seen him play in the past. However, I never commentated anything, so I've never seen it in the moment live. So I'm very curious to see how he's able to adapt on the fly. But it looks like it's going to be a trade. And Jack's going to find a second. But he's going to go down as well. Now it is a 3v3 scenario, but they know they're B. They know they're making this push. Colby looks for a bit more of aggressive push with the flash coming through and the Omen.
No charges, blinded.
The Omen blind. Can help him out a little bit as he takes a little pressure off of sight.
Spike planted.
You got Charlie in that main window area.
Ooh. You see how he checked his corners there?
Yes.
Huh. What?
There.
Oh! Unfortunately getting one tapped by that breach.
But they do have all the intel they need to retake the site. Colby trying to push through, but Xander finds one.
Xander find more.
Possibly.
Unfortunately not.
Very difficult scenario, but it is their breach finding four. That's very big for him. And now he's up 62 creds, able to buy someone anything if they need it. Crazy stuff right now. That's how I feel right now, and I'm sure that's how a lot of our players are feeling. Obviously, with these late night matches, and especially finals, it's difficult keeping yourself at 100% tip top shape. But you know, sometimes you got to do the best, and truly, our players are doing the best in all of their ability right now.
Ooh.
Oh, but it looks like Charlie's going to hold a very passive angle. He sees the drone coming in, so he's going to make a hard push, but he's not going to get rewarded for it. Now it's Jack. Oh, but Mason finds one.
Ooh. Ooh. An unfortunate turn of events here on round three, for sure. It's hard to see them get picked off one by one like that.
It really is. I mean, they are doing the best they can to make sure that, like, that they just keep their momentum running, that they just keep site held down. But like I said, managing those three sites,
it's difficult.
You can only devote so much attention to two of them, really, because then you just leave one person to defend all by themselves. And if you make a full five-man push to that site, are you going to be able to hold it down? But
Ooh, we do see Mason with the operator.
And the drone is coming out. Maybe spots him, but playing a way more passive push right now.
Oh!
And he's going to find one.
Can he find a second?
Possibly, but he is marked.
Ooh.
Close. Ooh. And that is the breach. Oh, but Xander is going to be able to find one before he gets hard stunned here. But he's going to make it out. And that's going to be
Kobe finding one.
He's going to go down. And that's Xander finding one. Now it's a 3v1.
Oh, unfortunately.
Oh, and there's
and
Charlie
securing that round. Xander picking up that op. All right. Wonderful round. We'll have to see if they can keep that momentum up. Oh, is that Judge Colby? It seems to be. Unfortunately, my wonderful co-cast had to step out for a moment, so it'll just be me and y'all chat. That's A-OK. Ooh, Mason tried to hold that line of sight with the op. Get it. Be big. Ooh!
My ult's ready.
And I was right. I was. Ooh! That breach going out. Mason falling back into that smoke. And using his ult. Taking out that breach.
No charges left.
Wonderful job. Three piece by Mason. Trying to watch those corners, watch those lineups there. Yeah.
One enemy.
Ooh. Mason Ace. Mason Ace is the round.
You should have seen your faces.
Ugh. A beautiful round from Mason. Welcome back, Jack. Let me just tell you, you missed a beautiful ace from Mason with the op.
I am so sorry
that you had to miss that.
Oh my gosh.
Wait for it. Wait for it.
Missing
one.
Four.
And two.
Five. For
beautiful.
The ace. I am so
you
jealous you
play?
Got to witness
Let's
such
play.
A sight. But now it looks like they're going to make an aggressive push.
Mason really just waiting it out.
Ooh.
Aww.
Trying to catch a shot, but now he knows where they are, and that's the opposing Jett ult coming out, not finding
Ooh.
Anything.
Shadows traveling.
Well, but Jack's gonna make it out. Flash coming out, trying to make something aggressive
Ooh.
Here.
He's able to get some damage.
But no one's going down. That's Charlie falling.
Fortunate.
But Xander knows where they are. He's holding that angle. He knows they're ready, but Jack
Ooh.
Is going down.
It's really just back
and
forth.
And that's Colby with
game.
One, and that's Xander with one.
Ooh, it's a 3v3 scenario, folks.
Colby
hanging
on by a thread.
What are you doing?
Oh.
Going down
that's
right
okay.
Now.
Oh, that's okay.
Mason's,
Shirley Mason with the op.
He's able to stop the ace, but he is not able to save the round. It is tied 3-3.
This game is just back and forth so far. Really don't know who's gonna.
Never know who's gonna be the one to pull through in the end.
Ooh. I'm gonna have to meditate after this game.
I'm gonna have to de-stress because I know one thing's for certain. All this anxiety building up from these past four games is not good for your health.
It's not. I was actually gonna do a final after this. It on your own time.
Oh, and that's
Colby
Kobe
picking
with one.
Off one.
But he just rotates away just in time. But he sees Jet.
Oh,
and he
getting
gets
two
in garage.
Is that a fight between Mason and the breach through a smoke?
But neither of them find each other.
The match just wasn't meant to be.
Flash.
Jack peek from Flash. We're not seeing anyone. Colby. Staying the best he can, but that's a two-man peek right there in Garage.
Now they know. Oh, Mason!
That was nasty. In unison, we are on the same wavelength right now. That's a flash coming out, but it looks like it's going to be a full A rotate. They know where they are.
30 seconds left.
Running.
And Xander has the op. He's ready.
He's got the chamber op too.
Here's the flash. He hears the plant. That's Jack going down.
Spike planted.
Chamber. Xander really living in that smoke there for a minute.
Finding anyone? I not finding anyone out just yet, but it looks like the angles are going to be hard held.
Prepare for hellfire.
One enemy remaining.
Oh! I don't believe he was able to get Molly off in time, so it looks like it's gonna be—he's gonna be able to stick it.
It's at half, I believe.
Last player standing.
No one else. Oh.
Does not have the time. No, he wasn't able to get it to half. That's very unfortunate, but that is two crucial ultimates for Brooklyn gone off the board now.
We have three.
And we do have three on our side, and Mason, if he's able to get three right here, is going to be able to get his knives up for the next round.
Mason is playing incredibly well today.
He really is. This is the top of his game. This is the best we have been able to see him, and I am super happy for him that he's able to get an ace on stream. I mean, this is something that's been coming all season, and it's finally time that it happens for him. So, good.
Not just an ace, though. An op ace.
An op ace.
Well, he used the knives.
That's just as clean, but that's Xander with two!
Beautiful. Getting that breach.
Oh, and Colby's going to be holding this hard angle right here. He's so ready for it. He's so ready. Look at this. The angle is covered. Like, if one goes down, that's just going to be another pick. It's just going to be another pick. It's insane. Look at that aggressive push right there.
Oh, and unfortunately, go down.
But that's the omen flash coming out.
Ooh.
Finding one.
Last player standing.
Oh, and that flash is going out a moment too late. So difficult to defend on this map.
They did have the right idea, however. Boys just played a little too aggressive right there for the push. They could have played a little far back, but you know what? That is just how it happens. But it looks like Mason's got the up for himself again.
I was just about to say that. It's okay. We're fine. Mason has his op back. Let's see it happen again. Can lightning strike twice? It's not really lightning. It's Mason.
And that's two detectives spraying through right there, not finding anyone. However, Jack taking a tiny bit of damage for himself, but that is Xander going down. But it has Jack finding one.
Ooh.
And Colby.
Colby knows Jet is there.
Oh.
Jet while blinded.
What a lucky spray.
Indeed. This is a 2v4 situation. Charlie hopping alt.
Down, finding mid. Two.
Oh,
unfortunate. That was a good good thought. However, just a little unable to execute super properly right there. The boys are doing their best to stay in this. It's only a 3-round deficit. That's not horrible, however, but it's just how are they going to be able to break Brooklyn's momentum? This has been such a difficult part for them.
Indeed. But keep in mind, again, because there are those three sites, right? And because we are a more attack-based, attack-based team. This first half,
doesn't really showcase what match could be.
That is very true.
Or at least not fully.
But it looks like they're going to make an aggressive push behind Brooklyn right now.
No charges.
Really?
Not finding anyone, but it looks like Brooklyn was slightly prepared for a push like that.
Spike planted.
Oh! Charlie finds one and Mason finds one, so now it's a 3v3. Charlie being pushed off a little high ground right there.
Bring them down.
No, I apologize, it is a 2v3. Dog not finding anyone. But Mason finds one. Charlie breaking his ankles a little bit.
Bring them down.
There's the Molly. And there's the eye.
Last player
getting
standing.
Found out. Charlie's going to take this battle. Oh. He's not going to be rewarded for it.
Unfortunate to see. That breach is really just... I mean, in the past two games, we hadn't really seen that breach doing too much in terms of elims. But now that breach is going crazy.
That is very true. I mean, the thing that Brooklyn's doing really well is being able to work off of not only that breach's initiation, but those chamber and those jet picks right there. I mean, the chamber jet Sova has really been the core of this team, making sure that nobody just peeks their head out. Nobody gets eliminated, that everyone makes their way onto site and that the rounds are secured. And UMW, you know, with the variance in comp and just changing it up, it's been really difficult for them to try to maintain such a strong hold in this game. However, you do have a good point. We are in a very attack-based team. We are very aggressive, so it's going to be very interesting to see how UMW adapts from this defense start to this attack end.
Oh, yeah. All right. The round is going to start here now. After. But
looks like we're having... some crazy spray coming out, but no eliminations have been found.
Xander gonna try and find some sort of pick.
We're not finding anyone and getting picked off, but Jack finds one of his own. He is so low health right now. He has to make sure that every moment in this counts. Mason does have knives, however. And Charlie getting a little jiggle right there, hearing some shots, so that's some good intel. It looks like it's going to be a full four-man rotation.
Flash.
Not getting Colby there with the Odin.
Colby Odin.
Omen Odin combo.
Oh! One goes down.
Oh, unfortunately, unable to find another one,
but... Brimstone, such low health right now.
Spike planted.
Not finding anyone. Maybe just a little off. Oh my gosh, that's insane right there. Jack has such the right idea, but such the wrong place.
Mason, watch heaven here.
Not seeing anyone. Oh, but they got the idea where Chamber is, but he takes one down with them.
Missing grabs one, avoids that smoke.
That's Jack trying to find him out. Gets the tap, but that's the ult. Ooh, and he finds it, and is he going to stick it? Nope. There's the breach ult. They just don't have the time.
But they can take out that breach.
No. Unfortunate. Those two ults have been coming in so clutch for Brooklyn on those post-plant scenarios, just denying UMW defuse after defuse after defuse, and it's really difficult trying to think how are they going to be able to come back from such a low round deficit.
Indeed. But keep in mind, this is the last round before the swap.
That is very true.
And I'm a hold true. I have faith in our boys. I know what they can do. I've been getting to know them over the past couple of weeks that I've been commentating these games, and I trust that they can make a comeback.
If there's any...
If there's anyone who can, it's these gentlemen.
I agree. If there's any people that is able to do... I mean, regardless, they have gotten... They have played fantastic. Such
wonderful Nova dodges, honestly.
Oh, unfortunate. Such a great blind, but such lucky sprays. Mason, you're going to make me go.
Planted.
You're going to make my head hurt.
You got it, Mason.
It's a 2v5. Xander and Mason going to the clutches right now. Let's see how these guys handle it. Doesn't have the second updraft, not able to find a top pick, but finds one. Oh! Finds two, but does fall.
Switching sides.
But now.
Here we are. Attacking side.
Let's see how the boys adapt on attack, how they're able to change and just overcome these challenges, but we are going to have a timeout coming out. Connor, give me some of your thoughts.
This has been tough, but Haven is incredibly difficult to defend on.
That is very true.
Insanely difficult, but 3-9. 3-9 comebacks happen all the time.
That is very true.
It can be done. It can be done. I know they can do it. I have full faith in them to do so.
I have full faith in these boys. I mean, we know the kind of skill they're able to put out. We know the kind of plays they are able to make. And if anyone is able to adapt to the loss they really are at right now, it is these guys. Get right back into the action.
Well, actually, we're gonna go back into my phase. But got this. All right. Start. Easily. Flashing, but
that's
Mason able to get
one.
A pick anyways.
That's crucial. The eye not
oh
finding
my
anyone.
God.
They're going to make their way onto site.
Such aggressive pushes.
Oh, he spots the breach.
Charlie's going to plant.
And Mason going to go for a very aggressive angle right now. Only 45. Oh, he's got the right idea. He sees them. They know where he is. And they still have the numbers advantage, and that's Mason with two. And that's Mason with three.
One enemy remaining.
Oh, and a beautiful round. What did I tell you? Up myself. I'm not even playing.
Yeah. We were joking in between rounds. We're like, oh my gosh, they can't breathe. And the boys are just like, you can't. You can't. Do you know who's playing this
game?
It's
so intense. It's just the energy in this room.
The energy in this room is off the charts. I mean, if they're
Ooh, an aggressive. Ooh! Wonderful job by Mason.
Able to deny that flash, and dash right there from Jet. Just so crucial.
They really just shut that.
They really did shut that down.
Yes.
It looks like they're gonna make a full push onto A.
Wonderful job,
Xander.
Xander gonna hold mid.
He can mid, but not seeing anyone. Ooh, but
finding that breach. That's for sure.
That's true. And now they're fighting a 5v3. And that's Mason finding another one, making it the 5v2. the eye not spotting anyone, so they have a little more time to work with.
Ooh, oh. Charlie saw that arrow go out, though.
And that's Xander finding Sova.
Charlie getting a little aggressive, and it works out beautifully. What a beautiful run.
My heart. My heart can't take the stress that I'm witnessing right now.
How do you think they feel?
Oh my gosh, but these boys are able to do it and do it and do it again. I mean, the kind of work they are putting out, they're pumping out right now is just phenomenal.
And also, don't forget, as our wonderful director has previously told us and the team, the second half of the game is much
very true.
We're really playing an endurance game here.
Match. And that eye spotting someone out. Is Mason going to be able to find anyone? No, he's going to be able to find one. I lied, but Xander finding the other one. Now it's a, I believe.
Yes.
Boys. Getting spotted out. And
unfortunate. That's okay. Xander with an op.
It looks like the full buy is going to come out, but Mason is saving because he does have those knives. I like that frenzy skin.
Oh, yeah, it's great.
It's a nice frenzy skin.
Same skin that Brandon has on his judge.
That is very true.
You think they just, like, took it off the judge?
Possibly.
You know, Brandon's just like, hey.
Yep. I'm subbing in. I'll sub you my skin.
Hey.
Ooh. And the double dash up.
I'd love
not
to see
finding
it.
Not finding anyone A-long right there. However,
Jack finding one in mid.
That's crucial too, because that's a lot of intel.
Ooh, Mason unfortunately going down, losing that ult. They know that.
But that's Charlie finding Jet.
And that's what a push Colby planting.
Spike planted.
Just TPing out of there, making sure he stays safe.
What happened to the op?
Cover going out.
Rushing back. Oh, now they know. Oh,
and it's Charlie.
One enemy remaining.
Oh, Charlie's so smart. He only had four bullets there. He couldn't do that much.
Oh, Charlie clutching the round. What beautiful gameplay.
Oh my gosh, Charlie.
Really making that split-second decision to play it safe, get behind cover, reload if possible.
And just heard that brimstone going for the molly. He was like, now is my time to strike.
We both play Smash. That was a pretty hard punish,
That was a very hard punish right there.
I need some water.
No. I spilled the water on me. Jack's not gonna spot anyone mid, however, he is going to play.
Face your fear!
Ult's coming out. Oh, he's got the right idea though. Now he's in a very difficult spot right now.
Oh, unfortunate. But that bomb is already planted.
And that's so much intel. He knows exactly where they are, and they know exactly how to play around it. I mean, look at Colby right now.
Flank. Oh, playing that expertly.
Doesn't find the one.
Oh,
lucky spray. But it looks like the boys are up in terms of people. It's the 2v2. Both are low, and both not finding the pick just yet. But playing to each other's strengths. Charlie with the lucky spray and finding it, and they're able to make it
out
safely.
Oh, and another wonderful round. Oh.
Almost finding the brimstone right there if he poked his head a little too far out. However, no luck.
Oh my.
There's not enough caffeine in this world
that is able to keep us awake right now. However,
I'll stay awake.
You want to know what is keeping us going? watching this game.
The absolute adrenaline rush that we are receiving right now.
There's another very aggressive push for you. Wow. Oh.
Ooh.
Taking down Jack, not finding anything.
Super aggressive.
But Colby taking down Chamber. 3v4.
Ooh. Get out of there, Charlie. Beautiful.
Not able to time it perfectly, but that is Xander finding one.
Spike down.
Now it's Xander Long with the op. He does not have bomb, sadly. That is on. And very difficult position for him. That is just
not really much you can do in that situation.
Such a util dump. There is nothing you can do to get out of that unless he had another TP. But again, those chamber nerfs make it really difficult for him to get out of that situation.
I thought the chamber nerfs didn't apply until like after this finals game.
I have no idea.
We'll cross that bridge later when we get there. At on the other team with an op.
This could be very big, but it also
chamber first.
Enemy chamber does have an op of his own now. Here's right there. They're coming out. There goes the knife from Jack. Not spotting anyone, but the eye does.
My.
Mason finds one. And Jack goes down. Charlie goes down. Mason goes down. Xander goes down, and now it's Colby. Colby finds one. A little off tempo. Colby finds two. Very close.
So close. And it is 7-12. We are down, unfortunately.
Match point.
Now, the boys are.
Tough spot.
They are in a very difficult position.
They lose this, they lose that trophy.
That is very true. However, regardless of the outcome, I could not be more excited watching these guys play right now. I mean, regardless of the outcome, it has been such a pleasure watching these guys come from the beginning of our semester to the grand finals right now in our inaugural season. I can't even talk. Just.
That is important to note. This is our first ever.
Bring them down.
And it's just been amazing.
We've just played.
They have the right idea. And that's Colby finding one. And that's.
And getting Jack back up.
That's going to be the res. And that's Colby finding two.
Charlie planting.
That's Colby finding three. Oh. And that is Jet with an op, but it is a 4v1, and bomb is planted.
Here.
It's such a slow walk. Xander knows exactly where
Xander.
He is. He's ready.
The dream is still alive.
It is still alive and running. They are able to bring it to this overtime. The boys are going to be able to have two rounds to play with here. However, we're still alive in the eco running well.
They're going to have to
very
win
much
four
in,
rounds in a row.
This is still very much in their favor.
They got it. I seen crazier shit. Yep. Can't say that.
Xander has the right idea right now. Here's some shots being fired, but no elimination created. However, the right idea is from both teams right now. Mason does have that guardian, and Xander does have that op. The angles are having to be played so safe right now.
Jack,
what a shot.
Beautiful elim.
Fantastic stuff.
Playing a little bit more aggressive.
Look how safe they're having to play. Look at that angle.
Spike down A.
But
Colby
wonderful.
Finds him and picks it up.
It is a 3v3 now.
I will give the credit. That was incredible discipline.
Oh, yeah.
30 seconds left.
Oh, Colby finds...
Beautiful job.
Colby finds Chamber, but there's the Brim. The Brim Molly. So now they got an idea of where Brim is. They still have time to play before Sova gets here. Sova dart coming out. Shock dart not finding anything. Oh, shock dart when Xander finds Brimstone in heaven, and now it is just Sova.
3v1.
Dartless. And he's just backing off. He does not want to fall. He is just going to save. The boys are in such a good position right now. That is three still kicking.
And it's official. Sova can't do anything.
Nope. And that's Mason finding the pick onto Sova. Really good.
I know. All right. Really intense match here.
Very intense. It looks like we're going to see a save on the side of Brooklyn. Jet with the Bucky. Sova with the Sova with the Spectre. And that Ooh. Is and that is Jet going down, and that's Mason finding two.
Cover going out.
And that's Jack finding one.
Spike down.
Sova unfortunately finding three. And that is
Defenders
that
win.
Is how it ends.
It's unfortunate.
Very unfortunate stuff. Congratulations to Brooklyn College for winning NECC's grand finals. However, all the credit into the world to our UNW boys.
Indeed.
Such a fantastic show they put on tonight. I mean, seeing how each and every single one of our players played, it truly was a treat. And seeing how far they've come, they should not be upset about this. They did the best anyone could ever hope for. Congratulations to second place for them, and such a strong area to be in.
Indeed.
What are your thoughts on the season as a whole now?
For first ever season for our wonderful, beautiful university to have a Valorant team. I mean, these boys really showed him.
Truly. But sadly, that is going to be it from us tonight. Thank you, everyone, for tuning tonight and watching your UMW Eagles in the grand finals game. Again, my name is Jack.
I'm Connor.
And have a good night. Good luck on your finals, everyone.